Welcome. It's good to be back in studio and not broadcasting from the road. It is the 25th day of August 2015 on this Tuesday worldwide broadcast. Again, I'm your host, Alex Jones. Joe Biggs is going to be in studio with us, along with State Representative Matt Shea from Washington State. There's a large contingent of state reps, most of them veterans, who are exposing the globalist agenda. We've had state reps on from Washington State that have exposed actual secret FEMA camps that are admitted to be prepared for the American people. And, of course, since that broke 3 years ago here on air, the Pentagon has declassified civilian inmate labor camp program operations and the massive expansion of that for civil unrest. We're not saying it's imminent. We're not saying Jade Helm is that. But clearly there's a buildup for war during a collapse using the social unrest and degeneration of order to scapegoat and target the liberty movement that is the strongest tent pole in the tent, undoubtedly. It's an act of sabotage against the Republic. And there is a sheriff in Spokane. We're going to review him today with Joe Biggs and the state rep, not because InfoWars is under attack, not because the sheriff's even that important by himself, but he's a good case study. Like if you were studying psychopaths, you might study the Manson family, Charlie Manson, or you might study Ted Bundy, or you might study Henry Lee Lucas. If you were studying Hollywood actors, you might study, you know, John Wayne or Marilyn Monroe. And so when we talk about federally controlled minion sheriffs who really hate patriots, and hate the liberty movement and just have a vicious preparation and a lust for this coming takeover, this guy's it. So we're going to look at how he lies. We're going to look at how he deceives. And then in the new year, because I'm about to launch the TV network, this show and the nightly news on satellite systems and some TV and cable systems, and we've got a lot of other stuff coming up that's going to be announced, but you can bet your bottom dollar I will be either late this year or next year going to Spokane. And, you know, the sheriff put out tweets like, come on, about time you come down here. Just really Creepville. And, of course, this is when we put out video, or we just linked to it, of a lady at a SWAT team fair with the MRAPs, and they're saying, well, these are for gun owners and constitutionalists. And the sheriff came out and said that we were liars and that InfoWars was threatening his deputies as if we were threatening him. And then they pointed out some comments on the forum. I mean, that could have been done by him. I'm not saying he did, but to say that some anonymous poster is InfoWars is like saying if somebody drops a piece of bubble gum on the street, that the city's responsible because you step on it and it's on the street. I mean, it's just no connection. And he's back doing it again, that he's getting death threats and that we're basically right-wing extremist terrorists and all this bull and attacking six members of the legislature. So he's an important microcosm. Vani Hari is launching a very exciting new initiative. She'll be popping in with us. We'll look at Russia basically banning all U.S. food imports. Gerald Celente is going to pop in for 30 minutes to talk about the accelerating collapse and more today. But in the first hour, get ready because I am wound up and I want to get into the economic situation, where that's going. I want to get into new Planned Parenthood video, has them joking about they needing 50 livers a week and complaining that sometimes it's just a blood clot and so they don't want to get scammed on the baby parts and they laugh. We've got just so much news to cover today. Hillary, more and more, it looks like, will be dropping out of the race as they prepare Biden. Thank you for joining us, my friends. I am your host, Alex Jones. It is good to be back here in Austin, Texas, after co-hosting and broadcasting from the road with David Knight and the rest of the crew. Very successful mission up to Toronto, Canada. I've been to Ottawa, their capital. I've been to Vancouver, out on the other side of Canada. But I tell you, Toronto is a really nice city. Feels very science fiction-y. Maybe it was just the totally blue skies and the high-tech looking buildings and Then I traveled across and went to Toronto Island and went swimming in the 70-degree Lake Ontario and saw the little fish swimming around. It was certainly a very, very beautiful place. There is so much good in this world, so much good in this universe, and it certainly needs to be celebrated, protected, and appreciated. And I, for one, just want to say I appreciate it, and I appreciate the gift of consciousness that God has given me, and I am very thankful for the fact that I am alive and sentient, and again, am extremely humbled by it. And I'm humbled by being here on air. I talk a lot about this before I get into the news. I'm just going to say it again because it's the best news I can give you. A lot of you out there of every race, color, creed around the world love freedom, hate tyranny. And you're fighting different permutations of it wherever you find it because it's just instinctive. It's at a cellular level. But you're not prominent. You're not a, quote, you know, well-known person in media, and so you don't get to really experience how many people are awake. And it really is a paradox because when you can't walk down the street anywhere, not just in the Western world, but in third world countries, without every fifth, sixth, seventh person stopping and shaking your hand, when you can't swim 100 yards off the coast in a great lake without people swimming by you and lifeguards on rowboats coming by and saying, hey, we're listeners, you've got to know there is a lot of people awake. And it's very, very humbling to have probably 500 or more of the 1,200 people that came to hear George Norrie, myself, and Nick Pope speak, stand in line for 2 hours to shake my hand and have me sign their autograph, and just the light in their eyes, how awake they were. How they were involved, how they gave me their business cards and their literature and their books and all the different things they were doing and how they're taking action, how they're battling Agenda 21, how they're battling fluoride, how they're battling globalism, how they're battling being disarmed, how they're battling big corporations getting tax exempt, but little companies not. But it's also frustrating because there's no way to shake 500 people's hands. And then really all give them attention and listen to what they have to say. And in that is the paradox of it's exhausting. A politician will just shake your hand. And I used to get mad when I shake a politician's hand. Even Pat Buchanan, I was a big fan of Pat Buchanan for both his runs. Went down in like 1992 when he was running. Took photos of him at the debate. In Dallas, one of the early presidential Republican debates, got a chance to shake his hand later. He's like, thank you very much, and just move the next person. And I wanted to say something to him. But he had 600 people's hands or more to shake. But my problem is I actually look at people in the eyes. I measure them. You can't help it. You make that approximation. You listen to what they have to say. It brings up a whole data set in your brain. And then they're whisked off a minute later, and the next person, reload. I mean, you talk about devastatingly exhausting. That's why I don't do more public events, because it is grueling. In fact, just even talking about it, I'm feeling drained right now. I need to shut up. It was very, very empowering, very, very fun, and great to feel that energy. But then the aftermath, again, is empowering, but also exhausting. But that's just the nature of the world. But I digress. It's just that I had more people come up to me in Toronto than I do in Austin, Texas. And Austin has been the number one city where the most people come up to me. I mean, sometimes every other person. And stares. And that's Alex Jones. That shows that people are aware of this information. And a lot of them are upset about it and call themselves fans. I just call it somebody that resonates with the truth and wanting to have a civilization. So I don't know how we translate knowing that there's that information out there that huge amounts of people are awake. I mean, I was in airports in Chicago connecting through and the airport in Toronto. And I had to fly out to Denver because the nanny was on vacation. I'd asked her to put my thing back in the safe, my passport. By the time I figure out I don't have it in the safe that morning, Friday morning, I call her. She wakes up. She goes, oh, my gosh, I put it in the zipper inside my purse. It's right here. I'm sorry. So I jumped on a plane, flew to Denver, stayed the night, caught a plane in the morning, flew to Toronto. But the hotel staff, it was like Fight Club. Because a lot of people don't say they're listeners. Just at the end, they go, you don't need to check out. I know you had two bottles out of the minibar, Mr. Jones, like the show. And it was a Chinese, attractive Chinese, obvious immigrant. She barely spoke English. But she was working behind the desk. And she just walked up to us and said, no need for you to check out, Mr. Jones. By the way, I'm a listener. And then both the women behind the counter behind her smiled at me. And I mean, it's like Fight Club. And Buckley's experience did help it set up the TV network connections and all the rest of it. About 75% of the time, Fight Club works to our advantage in that they're fellow travelers, to use the communist term, but fellow travelers in liberty and freedom. About 25% of the time, though, they're not fellow travelers. And they'll even say, no, you're not going to get on TV. You're not going to, the industry won't stand for this. We're going to, I mean, people will actually try to block us. But the great news is freedom has a lot more friends than it has enemies. I mean, even people that work for corrupt elements of the system, they don't want their kids growing up in a New World Order tyranny. They know it's dangerous. They don't mind the money and the power they've got off of it, riding it up. But they can feel in their gut how dangerous it is. So I'm done talking about the good news. So we got some bad news, obviously, here. But the good news is we know why we have the bad news, and we know how to stop it. And we know how to use the bad news that they want to use to get more power and more banker bailouts and more too-big-to-fail garbage to catapult around that sucker and achieve light speed for liberty. We don't have to fly into the sun. We can do that mathematical equation they've got for interstellar travel to go around the sun, use its gravity to slingshot around like judo and go to the next level. We can, as Ron Paul has said, in this critical juncture that he talked about in my film Matrix of Evil in 2003, that in a decade, maybe further out, the next 15 years, that these derivatives would melt down. They're going to try to get more planetary power, more world government, more cashless society as the answer to what they've engineered. And the answer is no, get rid of it and get back to truly transparent free market systems that are so successful and so wealth generating, they do create unbelievable opulence and civilization and spoiled rottenness. But if you remove the spoiled rottenness and bring back chivalry to a free market, and that means if you want to fight a man or you want to go out the street and shoot each other, it's legal to do so. I've studied history. We have to return total free market, but also chivalry. The gang thugs won't be acting tough in the streets anymore. Because if they mess with a family, you can demand satisfaction, and then their leader has to come out in the street with you by sword or by gun. And I mean, you go, oh, that's backward. No, that's not backward. That's what built civilization. That's why people were very, very polite. You go to places like Spain or Italy, where just 150 years ago, you smart mouth somebody, they call you out in the street. I mean, you think the American West was the only place where guys would go out in the street and shoot each other? That's what duels come from. That's where all of this originates from. Many of our founding fathers killed people in duels. But their crime rate was much lower overall. And most people were very, very respectful. Because if you were going to shoot your mouth off, you're going to have to make good on that check. Your mouth can't write checks. It can't cash. And there wasn't welfare, and there wasn't a society based on obsessing over language and all this garbage. What they do is they have a society where they remove responsibility, and then they replace it with political correctness as the new chivalry that's anti-chivalry, all about pulling down the strong, pulling down the honorable, and having gangs of ninnies be able to engage in whatever crime they want, but then you selectively can be shut down and persecuted by them. Now, I'm done ranting on those subjects. When we return, there is just a huge broadcast lined up today on U.S. stocks rally as S&P 500 rebounds from drop in correction. That obviously is the plunge protection team. China did that 3 weeks ago. It didn't work. Chinese market crash again and biggest collapse in 20 years. But don't worry, the Treasury Secretary says that we're not connected to China. And your head's not attached to your shoulders either. And we're going to get into Rutgers is telling people there's no such thing as free speech in their official manual. That's right. There's video we're going to play later. Jakari Jackson did a news report on it. Comedian jabs Hillary Clinton for attending Bilderberg on national TV. Hillary Clinton goes to those Bilderberg meetings. She probably hooked up with some guy wearing a goat's head. He goes on to say both parties are controlled and bad. Bill Burr, one of the top comedians in the country. With Conan O'Brien. See, people are getting off the script. They don't want either party. But Hillary's really bad. We're going to talk about that in a moment. Well, since I mentioned free speech and how it's under attack, Rutgers quietly removes no such thing as free speech line after outcry. University refuses to address controversy. Rutgers had posted to their official student guide online the quote, there's no such thing as free speech. Of course, the campus is supposed to be sacrosanct, the strongest free speech rules ever. And the people that call themselves the left took over the liberal movement in America, the classical liberal movement of Thomas Jefferson, of the Renaissance. George Washington's the founding conservative. This is in mainline history until about 60 years ago, by the way. This is not my opinion. George Washington's the founding conservative. Thomas Jefferson is the founding American liberal. And I like either one of them. You can debate either side of their views. Coming together, I'm in the middle of George Washington and Thomas Jefferson. I am not in the middle of the Republican and Democratic Party, who are different totalitarian movements, different flavors, different agendas, but at the end of the day, it's all about centralization and control. Outrageous that they would do that. But they've been forced to back off for now. But this is serious, beyond North Korea-level brainwashing, when all over the country, now the official biggest gay, lesbian, you know, group came out 2 weeks ago and said, ban the word mother, father, boy, girl, all of it. We control language. We rule. And it's not that I dislike people. I don't like even having to preface that. It's that I dislike anybody that wants to put me in a cult and tell me how to talk and what to do. And you're going to teach my kids this and that. Every TV show I turn on now, it's about transgendered and the dads are gay and blah, blah, blah. And it's just like it's a total agenda. There's an article here today about Hollywood needs transgender actors. Little experience required. Reuters. Here's the headline. Wanted transgender actors for Hollywood. Little experience required. As part of the admitted agenda to just put it everywhere. And what's behind the agenda? Not to accept some tiny minority. No. Which the elite are totally into and just totally control the dominant areas of New York, Milan, L.A. These people are not being persecuted, let me tell you. And now some elite fetish is being pushed as if it's the new national flag. This is cultural domination. Because if they can do this, they can get away with anything. And it reduces population. Now, speaking of Hillary Clinton, there's always a bridge too far. And the attempt to sell Jeb Bush, the attempt to sell Hillary Clinton, these two political dynasties that are joined at the hip together, in business together, is not working. And now we have the headline, give it up, Hillary. Almost half of Americans say Hillary should halt presidential campaign. And that's in big establishment polls. It's much higher. Meanwhile, Obama gives Joe Biden blessing for 2016 bid. CNN, get ready, folks. They're getting ready to flush Hillary. Draft Biden group circulates pro-Joe memo to DNC members. Meanwhile, Jeb Bush, desperate to gain ground on Trump, says Asians are abusing U.S. birthright citizenship. See, he's doing what Rand Paul won't do. Rand Paul, who I love, who is the best candidate, who I trust, who I know, who was the front runner until 3 months ago, will not touch the open border issue because of the libertarian left wing you know, that says it's libertarian to have open borders. It's not libertarian for people to come here and get everything for free. And the biggest group is not Mexicans coming in now. It's Chinese women. There's more Chinese women a week, some weeks 10,000 or more, who come here 2 weeks before having their baby. That's mainstream news. And they have the baby and everything's paid for. And then daddy can come in because mommy's already gets to stay as well. And that's not the 14th Amendment. It's a total scam. It's suicide to do this. We're going to go bankrupt. I mean, I can't go to China and have babies for free. It's not fair. And now even Jeb Bush is saying it. But Rand Paul, he won't do it. Because he's got people running his campaign that are crap.
We're on the march.
Excuse me.
The Empire.
You know, to say that the people running Rand Paul's campaign are horse manure is probably a little strong. I meant some of the directives, some of the political stances that are going on with Rand Paul are too milquetoast. And I say that from a friendly perspective, that if Jeb Bush knows he needs to come out against the Acre Babies to gain ground in the campaign, plus do the right thing, then what are you doing listening to your advisors? And I know that he helped not vote for amnesty, but he said he would have supported it if it would have been more transparent. Well, you can't have your cake and eat it too. It's not fair to pay for the 40 million illegals that are in this country. Now, they admit it's 40 million that came out in the census. Probably more than that. And 10,000 Chinese women a week. I mean, Jeb Bush, you can read his quotes. He talks about how it's organized by Chinese companies who then help get the women over here, basically sponsoring them, knowing that they're going to send money back to basically pay it off. These women are so poor in many cases, they can't even get here, folks. But once they get here and get the welfare and get the free baby paid for and all the rest of it, then they basically pay for the cost it took to fly them here as a tourist with a tourism visa, walk through 8.5 months pregnant, stay at a Motel 6, and then go have the baby. And, of course, daddy comes along a lot of times, too. There's a whitewash article. That's an older article about 10,000 in 2012. No, it's up to 10,000 a month in some cases. You can actually pull up a CNN article about it. And the CNN article is like an ad advertising it. How great it is. Hey, did you hear about this new cool thing? If I went to China and tried to make them pay for my wife to have a baby, they might harvest my organs. And I'm not even joking. That's what they do to political dissidents. They probably wouldn't harvest mine, though, because they think the government might make a big deal out of it. But if you're a Chinese citizen, you have absolutely no rights. And notice our media never even criticizes that anymore. And then when Jeb Bush came out and criticized the Anchor Baby movement, they came out with news articles saying it was politically incorrect. And he said, you know what? Big deal. Jeb Bush, people should chill out on the Anchor Baby controversy. He wanted the controversy. He wanted to be attacked. What I keep telling Rand Paul to do. Oh, it's CNN says, sorry, Jeb, Anchor Babies is a slur. No, it's not a slur. You don't control reality, CNN. Where if we don't want people to bring a baby here on purpose to make it a citizen, to anchor them to the United States and all the benefits, that's one of the best definitions of how about a parasite baby? How about a bloodsucker baby? How about a vampire baby? How about a freeloader baby? You people all day want to abort every baby you can get to, but then you want their parents to come here and sign them up day one for welfare and everything else when the country is going bankrupt, and then you sit there with your political correctness playing on our good hearts and telling us it's wrong. Is it wrong that China and Mexico don't have anchor babies? Nobody's got anchor babies but Western Europe and the United States, and it's because there's a deliberate plan to bring in large groups of people to balkanize the cultures against each other. That's just a fact. Are these foreigners themselves bad? A lot of them have broken the conditioning and know about the New World Order, and that concerns the globalists. But it doesn't matter because the majority end up going under socialism because that's the mammary gland shoved in their face at the trough the minute they get off the airplane. Now Hispanic Republicans defend Jeb Bush over anchor baby ahead of border tour, as if he needs to be defended. This is how gelded we've got. We apologize. It's now in the news that in some areas of California, Texas, New York, other areas, trendy areas like Austin, they'll apologize and say, we still have male and female bathrooms, but we're having them torn out soon to put in unisex. It's like, we don't use the word boy or girl or father or mother, husband or wife. We're good. We follow orders. We do what we're told. We're in a cult. And then they go to these things and have these liberal things called circling. And I'm sure there's some good ones, but there's also some bad ones, you know, Oprah Winfrey type stuff, where everybody just goes and hugs each other and goes, I accept you, and cries just randomly. And just, oh, it's just crazy. They get rid of families. They get rid of culture. They get rid of a future. They get rid of any roadmap. And then they bring in their new roadmaps that are just basically cults. That's what this is a cult takeover. The cult of Bernie Sanders, the cult of Hillary Clinton. And I'm not saying Jeb Bush is good. He wants to win. Bushes get into races to win. And he's going to have to sound more like Donald Trump to win. He would never do that. Bush wants totally open borders, globalism. His dad was the head of the CIA when they opened China up. He is a total Henry Kissinger minion and James Baker. I mean, you want 50,000 Chinese women a month they're having their babies? He'd do it. He's probably worse than Hillary because Hillary will have trouble getting her agenda through. If Jeb Bush gets in, he might actually get a bunch of it done because conservatives and libertarians will go to sleep for 4 to 8 years. Look at this article. Work in big tech for hire. Americans need not apply. A postgraduate student visa program is just another scheme to displace American technology workers. And why would you want to do that? Because it's a consolidation. It's a takeover. Are the Chinese women bad? Are the Mexican women bad? Are Eastern European women trying to get in with anchor babies? Are they bad? No. They want a better life. They heard they could have the baby for free, get some welfare, try to build a future. In many cases, they end up being productive. The point is that Americans don't even get this much support in many cases. Foreigners will get in-state tuition, but if you moved to Texas from New York, you don't get it. It's discriminatory. And why is it? To incentivize getting people here to exploit everyone. Talk about exploiting everyone. IRS finds yet another Lois Lerner secret email account, Washington Times. They've now found, what is it, 6 different secret accounts that this little cupcake has. And in the ones they've gotten, it's her scheming to go after anybody who isn't a communist, basically. She had yet another personal email account used to conduct IRS business. Tax agency confirmed in a new court filing late Monday that further complicated the administration's efforts to be transparent about Mrs. Lerner. The admission came in open records lawsuit filed by Judicial Watch. EPA Administrator Lisa Jackson, I'm going to say it again, had 2 secret emails with code names just like Lois Lerner and just like Hillary, and she had to resign. Petraeus had to plea to a felony over some papers at his house. I mean, this is just crazy. They use national security like a sycophantic idol to violate the Bill of Rights and Constitution when the real national security is long gone. We've been conquered by foreign offshore corporations that have 800,000+ foreign intelligence operatives with top-level security clearances above top secret running everything. We've already been taken over like France in 1941 with the Vichy French. We are conquered. Now they want to come in with the Agenda 21, the regulations, the rules, take your land, take your property, raise your taxes, shut down your business, shut down your employer, harass you, shut down the local bank, federalize everything, force GMO seeds on you, force inoculations on you and your family. Tell you you can't use the word father and mother, boy or girl. There are public schools across the United States now banning the word boy and girl. Imagine the freakishness of don't say boy, don't say girl in kindergarten. And the kids learn there are no boys, there are no girls. It's hurtful you're a little girl. It's hurtful you're a little boy. You're inherently bad because you're a mammal. I'd expect a 6 foot or 3 foot tall green Martian alien in a spacesuit to be talking like that. You understand? That's what aliens would come to the planet and do and say, it is bad that you are breeding. It is bad that you have male and female. Women turn on male. Male turn on female. Take these shots. We love you. Never mind everyone dying around you. We come in peace. We come in peace. We come in peace. I mean, it's the same thing. The globalists are that alien, that evil, that out of control, and we sit here worse than the Jim Jones cult as they load the cyanide in the Kool-Aid, in the grape Kool-Aid, and the cherry and strawberry and peach Kool-Aid, as they load the Kool-Aid. We are just here sucking it down, and it's now reached outer limits, twilight zone, bunker land, crazy town, insanity. Meanwhile, ISIS is running around Syria, blowing up ancient Roman and other temples, stuff even better than what's in Rome. They are just blowing it all up in mushroom clouds. And this is who our government funds and runs. I mean, just, we have a government of pure evil. And the longer we don't admit it to ourselves, the worse things are going to get. I mean, we don't just have kingpin government that wants power and prosperity and to skim off the top and rule it and be good old-fashioned narcissistic emperors. You can actually at least get a civilization out of that. We have people that want to just screw everything up and have everything upside down and just the most sickening, degenerate, anti-human filth the world could ever imagine. That's what we become. And it's thoroughly disgusting. So Lois Lerner, not in trouble. Lisa Jackson had to step down. Hillary, done something far worse, hadn't gotten in trouble yet. Meanwhile, The Observer reports anti-American sentiment surges in Russia as U.S. officer taunts from his perch at Fox News. And I like Lou Dobbs, but he has this general on, Robert H. Scales, who says, quote, it's time to start killing Russians. And, quote, we need a bunch of dead Russians, and then they'll back off. I mean, that's like saying go up to a honeybee hive and attack it with a baseball bat, and the bees are going to run. No, they're not. I mean, this general, we've been picking on Iraq and picking on Syria and picking on Libya. Russia is not Libya. Russia is not Iraq. I mean, who is this guy? Some retired general shooting his mouth? Imagine Eisenhower, even if he went to war with somebody, shooting his mouth off about, we just need to kill a few Russians and then they'll back off. Yeah. They'll just kill a few of them. They'll run with their tail between their legs. No, they won't. I got an idea. You go over there on their doorstep and you start a fight with them. You send your sons, your daughters, punk. Not mine. You want to blow the planet up? Go. I saw some article where there's a billionaire group looking to launch their own Mars colony. I tell you what, everybody that wants to kill each other and attack Russia for no reason, you can go to Mars and fight with each other. How's that sound? Then they'll all just mutate themselves and come back as little green men. Maybe that's what happened, actually. I'm being sarcastic. Okay, I haven't gotten any of the video clips, and there's a ton of them. I haven't gotten into China yet. We covered it in great detail yesterday. They have gone in with the plunge protection team to jack up the U.S. stock market. That's completely artificial. And some people say, hey, man, just cheerleader this whole thing, and it'll be okay. No, when we have 2.2 quadrillion in derivatives, when we have most stocks overvalued 5, 10, 15 times, depending on the stock, when you have the fact that if any of these billionaires ever tried to spend their money, you'd see inflation kick up so fast it would make your head spin. And now the Federal Reserve is signaling they're not going to raise interest rates. They're going to maybe lower them. How do you lower them from zero? They just give themselves free money. That's what that means. And the Chinese have lowered their interest rates along with lowering their currency 3 weeks ago. That will accelerate the global devaluation of currencies on top of a depression. So the money's worth less, but they're actually destroying the real economy, and the elites are only keeping the money for themselves and not letting a lot of it get out into the economy. And so you're seeing depression. That's why you'll go to one city and it's a dead wreck. You'll go to another, it's a wreck. But right next to it will be some thing that looks like it's Mount Olympus of just huge castle-like homes and jets and helicopters landing. And there'll be fences and armed military out front. I mean, this is already happening in Europe. And you're like, what's that? Oh, that's the rich district. And in the future, they'll just be flying up to their Elysium bases. That's a whole plan of Wernher von Braun. Well, I mean, what, you think that movie with Matt Damon figured all that out? I mean, this is real stuff they're talking about. Mars bases, undersea bases. They're already launching their own private ships, bigger than major cruise liners, that then dock in our cities during emergencies. The elites are running to ships offshore. And now we've got SpaceX, Elon Musk reveal Mars colonization ideas this year. And at least Elon Musk gets us all thinking. So Chinese market crashed again today in biggest collapse in 20 years. It had drugged down U.S. markets Thursday, Friday, and Monday. But to make the Treasury Secretary, can we cue him up one more time? To make the Treasury Secretary for Obama sound like he's smart, they just infused who knows what. It's secret. The president's open market team, the plunge protection team, or the Committee on Open Markets, technical name. Who knows what they pumped in to send it back up to their select stocks, setting the precedent that we have a rigged market, as the yuppies beg for that, so he can sit there and tell everybody that, see, China doesn't affect us, and the laws of gravity don't affect. You watch this week, next week, a month, maybe tomorrow, that stock market, if you look at the graphs, is going to start going down, 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 because it's so overvalued. And it wouldn't matter if it was so overvalued if it wasn't our whole economy. It'd be fine to speculate and ride it up and down if you had the money, like a casino, if it wasn't the whole economy. But they set it up where the artificial economy is everything to control us, making us a one-crop economy, fiat, BS, paper, and propaganda. So we're a two-crop economy. Let's go to the clip.
But I will say that China's markets are still pretty much separated from world markets. They're obviously moving towards being more integrated, but right now they're not. So you're not going to, I don't think, see the direct linkage there. I think the concern that is a real one is, what does it mean about long-term growth in China?
Okay, so there's Jack Lew. There's no linkage with China. They're just the number one country that owns our debt. Then the private Federal Reserve is the private bank that owns even more than they do. And we get something like 70% of our baubles and goods from them. But there's no linkage. There's no linkage at all. We just got 10,000 Chinese women a week coming here to have babies for free. Coming up for about 40 minutes of the next hour, Joe Biggs and a state rep are going to be on with us talking about the ongoing demonization by the feds at the sheriff's department and police department level against the liberty movement, including members of state legislators. And we have a poster child for this totalitarian movement who is the sheriff in Spokane. We're going to spend some time on that, looking into that microcosm to understand the larger picture. You know, the famous clips where the SWAT team guys saying, yeah, we've got armored vehicles for the patriots, the gun owners, the constitutionalist. And then the sheriff came out and said we were liars, that they didn't say that, but that we were scum and that we were death threatening him. Just all lies. And the guy's either trying to bait us or he's super stupid. And I don't think he's stupid. So we're investigating him. We know the ADL, Southern Poverty Law Center, have taken over a lot of departments around the country. They've been kicked out of departments. They've been sued. They've gotten in trouble. They have the media act like they're reputable organizations. As far as I'm concerned from researching them, they operate basically, you hear about Scientology being pushy and doing stuff behind the scenes? Huh. And I don't support what Scientology's been doing, you know, stuff like that, reportedly. But, I mean, this is just way beyond that. It's like basically Democratic Party operations, clandestine operations. Remember what the White House-run Media Matters got caught doing 4 years ago, and Politico even wrote a no apologies whitewash where they said our job is to infiltrate libertarian conservative organizations, get hired inside them, and sabotage them. I mean, if you get them in your building, they'll work for a year and then activate on you and start just destroying stuff, doing whatever, getting you sued, whatever. I mean, they don't play games. They are professionals. They infiltrated and basically set up Elohim City, the white supremacist compound, 2 years before 95 and had that as a cutout. They ran the organization. They don't play games. And it's just disgusting watching them do their work. But we are investigating the sheriff. He's been trying to bait us into coming there. And then when we went there just to cover it and have a rally and try to be his friend and try to educate him, he made more false statements and fled the county. They're like, oh, sure, the sheriff's here. He'll talk to you. Oh, sorry, he's on vacation now for a week. And then was seen the next day, scared to talk to us and lied. And I guess he thinks lying's cute and lying's funny, so that's all coming up. There's new Planned Parenthood video where they're making jokes about dead babies and their livers, and that ties into Satanists showing up to show support for Planned Parenthood, this time in Detroit. I'm telling you, anywhere you show up, Texas Capitol, Detroit, New York, California, you just show up at a pro-life event and people will show up going, Satan will get you. Ah, the baby is ours. Ah. And you're just like, whoa. They'll even attack you. The media will be like, look at these cute, loving people that came out to confront the evils of Alex Jones. I mean, it's just, it's incredible. One of them ran and jumped in a trash can when we chased him because he grabbed our microphone. He just slithered into a trash can. He had green skin. I'm not joking, just like a zombie. He wasn't acting. He was, babies. And the other ones that were with him were going, death, murder, kill babies. Ah, I love Satan. I'm fat, I'm ugly, I mean, it's just like, what the? That's who we're fighting. This is who rules us? And they had communist flags? Oh my God. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be laughing. These people have taken over, and 50-plus million babies' blood is on their hands, and they love it. Infowars.com. Stay with us. We're going to cover it all coming up. Infowars.com. Coming in the next segment, Joe Biggs, who went out to Spokane last year, is going to be in studio with us with State Rep Matt Shea of Washington State. The bizarro sheriff has been up to it again. And again, we're not covering just what one sheriff's doing. This is what the federal training has done. It's why I have clips from Ohio, from Indiana, from Michigan, from Washington, and others saying we have the MRAPs, the armored vehicles, for the constitutionalist. And we have those clips coming up in the next segment. And we have the special reports. Police, armored military vehicles needed for constitutionalists with firearms. We point out they're preparing for war, and then they put out disinfo stories. Oh, Jones says martial law is going to happen by September 15th, under Jade Helm, and they're going to confiscate your guns. No, I didn't. I said they're training to confiscate our guns. That's in the Army Times. It happened during Katrina. Stop acting like this isn't happening. Remember, like 5-6 years ago, there's no such thing as a TPP. There's no such thing as an Atlantic transatlantic agreement between the NAU and the EU. There is no global government. There is no carbon tax. I have Al Gore in 2007 in Congress in my film Endgame looking at the camera and saying, There is no plan for a carbon tax. None of these initiatives have anything to do with it. And they're like, but you own the company that's going to have the carbon credits. And Al Gore goes, and you also believe there was no moon landing? Now, notice now, it's all admitted, all out in the open. The Pope calling for it. A bunch of countries have it. They're ramming it through here. But Al Gore will still come out and say, there is no carbon tax. There is no income tax. 2 + 2 = 5. If you have a business, you didn't build it. Joe Biden's not going to come after any of your guns. Remember those speeches? They are a pack of criminal liars. But it comes down to us. We are to blame for the fact that we are so tolerant of this. We're going to go to break and come back and go over all of this. Briefly, didn't plug anything last hour. Both shows plug every segment. And the reason I say that is it's important to support InfoWarsStore.com. InfoWarsLife.com is a subdivision of that with the high-quality nutraceuticals, because that's what funds about 70% of our operation. Then we've got sponsorship and PrisonPlanet.tv. And quite frankly, we're going to have to do some fundraising here to be able to fund the next year, especially with the economy being in trouble. Everybody sees it. Everybody feels it. I know it's hard to support us for a lot of people. Folks that have means and are upper middle class or wealthy, you're really crazy if you don't start supporting outfits that are fighting for liberty. But regardless, whether you're a working man or filthy rich, we have products everybody needs and should use, like Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine X2, Game Changer, OxyPower to flush out your upper and lower intestines, Game Changer, Prostaguard, the highest quality formulation, lowest price out there for a high-quality nutraceutical that targets healthy prostate. We also have Silver Bullet that I'm not going to sell out of Silver Bullet this time, because it's going to be months and months till we get more. And I've calculated what it'll take to sell out at regular price over the next 2 months. So I'm going to sell what we've got, and then I'm going to cut off and keep enough back at the regular price so we don't sell out by the middle of October. This will probably sell out by Thursday or Friday. I'm saying, and by sell out, the amount we have to sell discounted. 30% off one bottle, or buy two, get two free. This is already the highest quality, lowest price out there. Okay? So you buy two, get two free. You're talking about enough to use currently and a long-term supply. It stores for many years. You cannot find a better deal, and your purchase supports the broadcast. Get two Silver Bullets, colloidal silver, 30 parts per million. Get two free, or get one bottle, 30% off, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Now well into the second hour of the worldwide broadcast, we have Gerald Celente, Trends Forecaster, joining us to talk about China sliding again yet today, the Federal Reserve coming in and propping up the stock market. China did that 3 weeks ago. It worked a little bit. Now the free falls back. We expect to see that same trend here. We wish the stock market wouldn't go down, but it's way overvalued. So we'll be breaking that down in the last 30 minutes of the broadcast today. Also coming up, we're going to play clips of the latest chilling Planned Parenthood video released today, I guess the eighth video, that has them joking about trying to buy 50 baby livers a week, and the fact that sometimes they're getting ripped off and they're only blood clots. And they say, you know, what's happening? Are the dead babies crawling out of their containers? You know, where are the organs? And making all sorts of sickening statements. And that dovetails with footage CNS News got of Satanists in Detroit who've put up a Baphomet statue going around in support of Planned Parenthood. And just no matter where you go, Satanists just appear. I'm telling you, go out, demonstrate, announce you're doing it. Every time I've done it for 20 years, and I've only done it probably 16, 17 times, Satanists have shown up. They'll come over and say, you know, I worship Satan. We're going to kill you, or we're going to get you, or we kill babies. You're never going to stop us, and stick their tongues out. And the thing is, they're so weak, you know why they worship such a pathetic creature as Satan. Whether you believe in Satan or not, a lot of serial killers worship the devil. So it shows the mental illness. Now, joining us till about 45 after, our state rep, Matt Shea, VoteShea.com, is his website, and Joe Biggs. Joe Biggs last year went out to Spokane because it was national news when we played a clip of the sheriff's deputy and the SWAT team at a Walmart saying we have this MRAP for constitutionalists and people who are stockpiling guns, who statistically have the lowest crime rates in the country. Look it up. And then we have other clips from Indiana and Ohio and Michigan and you name it. Same thing. This is the federal talking point. You've been given armored vehicles for the veterans, for the gun owners, for the Christians, for the constitutionalists. That's national news. So six, and now it's seven members of the legislature are really great patriots. They even wear the InfoWars 1776 pin. They sent me a photo of that. It was awesome. We had to dig that up from their Twitter and put it up. I forgot to tell the guys about it. And there's just so much data to go over here. I could talk a million miles an hour. It's better that I just turn it over to Joe Biggs, turn it over to Representative Shea, and also turn it over to the sheriff himself. We're not going to play the whole thing, but when we played this video, he came out and said we're liars, that it wasn't for constitutionalists. And then he came out and said that InfoWars was death-threatening him. And then in his next breath said, that's why we need the armored vehicles for the constitutionalists. So this guy is either one of the worst liars I've ever seen or something's wrong with him. And I mean that very serious. That's my opinion. I mean, I don't want to fight with the sheriff. I'm not some type of police officer hater. In fact, I respect the office of the sheriff. It's elected. That's the most respectable constitutional law enforcement office there is. And we have sheriffs across the country, from Milwaukee sheriff to you name it. We have the sheriff on all the time. I've had him on for 20 years that launched the sheriff movement to try to get liberty back, of course. So it's very painful to see this, and something's going on. He's either trying to bait us, or he's being manipulated by the Southern Poverty Law Center or some other organization. Let's play the clip that started all this last year of the sheriff's deputy saying it's for constitutionalists. Here it is.
Well, this, the nice thing about this piece of equipment is that if somebody is directing fire toward a team that's trying to get in, they safely can, they can pull right up to a front. Take enemy fire and still try to address a threat without being fear of getting shot.
So I'm thinking that is totally appropriate in Iraq, but where, what kind of a situation in the U.S. would you see that happening?
I mean, we've got a lot of constitutionalists and a lot of people that, stockpile weapons, a lot of ammunition. Weapons here locally.
Okay, and then he said the tape was edited, so we put out the entire 12-minute tape we got from the listener. But again, we weren't even breaking this. It was already out for a week. We just wrote a story about it. DrudgeReport.com picked it up. Fox News picked it up. And then we'll play later in the broadcast other sheriff's deputies at other departments saying the exact same thing with the exact same MRAPs. I mean, it's chilling to have armored heavy vehicles, wheeled tanks that, you know, Joe fought in Iraq and Afghanistan, in America. And they tell us it's for us. The Democratic Party basically does. And of course, a lot of these reps that are fighting back against this are veterans themselves. And the sheriffs come out and call them traitors and run down their service. Kind of like when you criticize Jade Helm, they kind of said, oh, he claims he was in the Army, when they know you were in Rolling Stone, GQ, and in Army Times. I mean, you were somebody they pushed in front of the cameras because you were in a heavy combat unit.
Yeah.
And then they're like, oh, maybe you were in the military. Maybe, you know, Matt Shea was in the military. Maybe these other people. It's really crazy how they try to deceive. So, Joe, what do you think's really going on here? And then we're going to go to Matt Shea.
Well, this guy, this sheriff walks around with blinders on. And then the fact that he's using these YouTube comments as threats, we get death threats on YouTube.
I mean, every day.
That's just what happens on YouTube. I mean, I've got some of them right here that says, I hope your MRAP and your SWAT team takes you down. And, you know, this is something that they said that was on an InfoWars comment board that was in the Inlander article.
Cops, and then they said that we said this.
Yeah, we don't.
This is a major cover story.
Anybody
that hundreds of thousands read saying we're saying kill cops.
Yeah, anybody can log on to YouTube. Anybody can post anonymously and put some kind of comment up. It has nothing to do with us. No one at InfoWars condoned that. No one here wrote that. So how does that have to do with us?
Well, they're going along with the sheriff, because first he said we said it a year ago, and now they're running it saying that we're saying it.
Yeah, they're saying the InfoWars behind
We could go on the Inlander and write that and say they said it.
Yeah, exactly. So all we're doing is trying to confront the fact that this guy is out of control completely. The fact that he says he's going to use these MRAPs for constitutionalists. What's wrong with being a constitutionalist? What's wrong with wanting to stand up for that? And then the fact that in like some places, like in Washington, if you call 911, you have to say that you're a veteran, not because they're going to approach you differently if they come to your home. There's a huge problem going on.
It's really crazy. The people that have hijacked our government want to start a war with people in America that still are Americans. I mean, it comes down to that. If you're just mainline mom and apple pie, you want low taxes, right to defend yourself, private property, you're just a good, hardworking person, you're the enemy because criminals have taken over and they're trying to manipulate police now into believing that we're the enemy to have a civil war. That's my view. We, of course, can give people the name of this sheriff, talk more about him, get some background on him, but they've got mainstream media, national TV, you name it, really working with this sheriff to demonize the liberty movement that's growing in Washington State. Representative Matt Shea, thank you for coming on with us.
Thanks for having me on again, Alex. And Joe, good to see you again.
You too, sir.
Tell us your view on all this and what you think's happening.
Well, so this sheriff is completely out of control. In fact, I would use the word he's becoming unhinged. And this started several years ago when he brought the Southern Poverty Law Center here to Spokane, Washington, to train sheriff deputies. I actually sat in on that training to see exactly what they were teaching. I had my aide with me. We took very copious notes. And he put up on the screen there. And by the way, this sheriff tries to claim that he didn't know what the training was going to be about, and yet his picture was in the bottom right-hand corner of the slideshow. So he tries to claim he didn't know, but he knew exactly what was in this training. And during this training, they put the picture on the screen of the leader of the We the People movement down in Pullman, Washington, Jeff Williams, put it up there, and they said that he was a domestic terrorist or an example of one. Guy has never been tried, never been convicted. In fact, I don't think he's ever even been investigated for that. And yet the Southern Poverty Law Center was demonizing this individual. Now, it was brought to the sheriff's attention, and instead of apologizing and saying, hey, I messed up, this shouldn't have happened, I'm sorry, it took 6 months and several meetings of local area constituents and leaders to get that sheriff to send an apology letter to Jeff Williams. And then a couple years later, when this deputy finally says this out in the open on camera that the MRAPs are for constitutionalists, this sheriff, again, doesn't apologize. He just tries to say this was taken out of context. Alex, I don't know in what context that would ever be okay to say something like that. And myself and many others that believe in freedom and liberty, that believe the Constitution means what it says, we're sick and tired of being demonized. It's the people that are ignoring the Constitution in this country that are the problem. It's the people like this sheriff, who, by the way, has been investigated for assault, for pumping private gas into or public gas into a private vehicle. He's said publicly that he wants to stop all lying in his department. And yet there was a murder of a pastor, a pastor literally on his own property here in Spokane, Washington. There was a $2 million settlement from that case because it was very clear that pastor was shot unlawfully. That deputy continued on his department. And by the way, during the investigation, it was uncovered that deputy lied on his employment forms about outside employment, which was a sex toy shop he was running with his wife, lied on that and was never fired for it and was only fired this year.
And he was in an unmarked vehicle, right?
And he was in an unmarked vehicle.
I think they've got something planned big for this sheriff. I don't know if they're trying to bait patriots in the area to try to, you know, have some incident. But clearly, this is a key area. That's why we're focusing in on it. It's got a lot of patriots, a lot of constitutionalists, a lot of veterans, a lot of conservatives, one of the most awake areas in the entire Pacific Northwest.
Indeed.
And we have State Representative Matt Shea here breaking this down with us. I just want to know why he poses on the cover of major newspapers and magazines standing on the Gadsden flag and standing on basically the American people when that's one of the founding flags of this country. That flag predates the American flag. That's one of the first battle flags. It's the Marine Corps uses it. The Army has it. I mean, this is just really arrogant and aggressive. And let's pull back. This is a tiny window because most departments are smart enough to either reject the Southern Poverty Law Center, ADL, or they keep the training secret. We told everybody the MRAPs is for us. Now we've got videos of departments all over the country or their manuals saying it's for us. I'm going to repeat this. Thousands of heavy armored vehicles with 50 cal machine guns, you name it, have been delivered free of charge, or in some cases sold, to departments for war with veterans and gun owners and conservatives. This is outrageous. It's criminal. It constitutes an attempted soft coup by the Obama administration. And when people like Representative Shea and others have the will to go in the face of this tyranny, they get demonized. And let's talk about his demonization of you. In fact, they gave me the report a few weeks ago. If somebody reprint that newspaper and bring it to me, because it's in a bunch of the newspapers, but this is a big paper there. You read this stuff, you can't believe they're saying it or implying that we want to kill people or that you want to kill people. And he says that you're out of control as a state rep. He's really escalating the rhetoric when we've never said any of this. What do you think's really behind this? Because I really see the pieces and it doesn't look good.
Well, I think there's two parts of it, Alex. The first part is they're trying to bait liberty and constitutionalists. Liberty movement folks are trying to bait us into doing something. That's the very first thing. The second thing is they're trying to come after veterans. And in particular, this sheriff's supporters tried to denigrate my service record in last year. And I served two combat tours overseas, Alex, in Bosnia and in Iraq both. And I got to tell you, I am furious. This sheriff would try to say that I'm some sort of an extremist. I'm some sort of a domestic terrorist. When I sat there and I fought overseas, the very people that he should be more concerned about here in this country.
Right. I forgot the new article from last week. He now compares you to ISIS. He actually says, like the terrorist in ISIS. What's going on with that?
Well, he says he compares us to ISIS. He compares constitutionalist to ISIS. Then he tried to walk back and say that was taken out of context. Again, I would say there is never a context in which you say that word in the exact same sentence, that acronym ISIS, in the exact same sentence, that you're implying that constitutionalists are domestic terrorists. You don't say that. And that's what's so alarming about the sheriff. On top of the video that he did last year, October 20th, 2014, where he says, I can affect your freedom and take your life. Mm-hmm. We need to be asking questions of this sheriff. That's our job. And this sheriff, instead of blaming victims and blaming other people, should answer for his actions. And I have publicly asked that he resign. And Alex, I'm here to ask you today, we need you up here in the InfoWars spotlight on this sheriff, because very clearly there is something going on in this area. In fact, there's kind of a tale of two sheriffs going on. We had the VA come up Priest River, Idaho, and threaten the firearms rights of a veteran here a week and a half ago. And Sheriff Darrell Wheeler stood in the house with us and said, no bureaucrat is going to take away the God-given unalienable rights of one of my citizens and one of my constituents.
Yeah, tell us about this hero sheriff that we should get on the show and interview versus this bizarro sheriff.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Darrell Wheeler said, I think what every sheriff should be saying, that bureaucrats cannot take away any sort of God-given unalienable right.
There's no judge, there's no jury. They've even said they're going to use, Obama announced a month ago, the VA model for the FBI now, for regular citizens to just magically take your gun like a no-fly list. You don't know how you get on it. They just come take your guns.
Well, yeah, the VA sending out letters like that to veterans all over the country. Hey, sorry, we don't think that you're quite stable enough. You're not able to handle your finances, so the VA is going to come in and seize your weapons.
Now they're announcing all Social Security recipients that take automatic wire transfers. This is the FBI announced this, will be considered financially unable to take care of themselves and basically will now be wards of the state. Your guns will be taken.
Well, it's only going to be a matter of time before Sheriff Ozzie Nezevich brings in Snopes to help solve crimes as well, to help with the SPLC.
Joe, I can't believe that I just said on air that a month ago, because you can pull it up, mainstream news, that they're now going to have the VA model go after people on Social Security saying that, you know, it's like their neck's broken or something. They can't have guns. Well, their neck's not broken. Just because you have a money transfer and do automatic wire transfer of your check, that means you can't take care of your finances. And then the Congress came out in the Washington Times the next day in the Hill newspaper and said, Congress warns Obama not to implement. That isn't enough. He's going ahead with it. Representative Shea, can you believe it's moving this quick? I mean, this is really bold.
It is very bold. The last 2 months have seen just a massive escalation of what is very clearly a movement toward tyranny, no question about it. And up there in North Idaho, and this is what's going to happen across the country for all your viewers, all your listeners, this is what's going to happen across the country, where they're going to have a doctor say, and they didn't say that he was mentally deficient or mentally incompetent. They said that he was not competent to handle his VA benefits. That's what they said about this veteran. And therefore, under the Brady law, that he could no longer own, possess, buy, or sell a firearm. And it's very interesting. After we went up there, we stood on the front lawn when the VSO showed up there. We had the sheriff with us, and the VA completely backed down and began running away from this as fast as they possibly could. The very next business day, so the next Monday, the same doctor who had made that decision and had never followed up over 8 months after this gentleman had a stroke to see that he'd actually recovered from the stroke, wrote a letter and said magically, "Oh, he's all better now. He's totally fine."
These are test trial balloons. They have said it. They are coming after everybody. And I'm telling you, if they try to disarm millions of people on Social Security, it's going to start a civil war. And I think that's their plan. So how do we not respond? Well, we don't get violent. We politically get involved, like this state rep, and go and stand in the doors, draw attention to it, show video of it, and it will backfire.
I think that one of the great examples of this was just a video we posted here over the weekend, again, involving this sheriff's office and a particular Deputy Lawhorn, interesting name, by the way, where there was a pro-life protester on a corner, completely legal. Four ladies come up and begin harassing him, hurling violent and vile insults at him right in his face. A homeschool mom pulls over and begins filming, and it ends up that this guy, the guy that's protesting, instead of the four ladies, is the one that is put in handcuffs and detained.
Yes.
And treated abysmal.
In fact, I saw that video. Give us the name of that. We'll put it up on screen because this is what we're talking about. There are more patriots than there are pro-death people. The woman pulls over to document. Then she's able to catch this sheriff's deputy following the Southern Poverty Law Center Soviet roundup plan to, I've got one of these pro-lifers. Let's take him to jail. Because they hate the fact that the weekend before last, there were thousands of demonstrations across the country. Some of them 500, some of them one person. Some of them 1,000, some of them 20 people. But every person going out did something by drawing out the tyranny, by showing what these evil forces want to do. I mean, if that doesn't show how wicked this sheriff is, nothing does. There it is. Spokane sheriff's deputy harasses peaceful pro-life protester, threatens witnesses on video. This is what it is to have a hardcore communist organization. That's what the Southern Poverty Law Center is. Just hardcore evil running our sheriff and police departments. I mean, this is sick. Representative Shea?
And the perfect example of how to act in this situation is what this whole homeschool mother did. She remained calm. She remained very respectful. And she demanded that they state the reason she could not be there. And this is despite the fact that I want to read this for you, Alex. It's despite the fact that in the sheriff's own standards of conduct, it reads this: the Spokane Sheriff's Office recognizes the right of persons to lawfully record members of this department who are performing their official duties. Members of this department will not prohibit or intentionally interfere with such lawful recordings. They're not even abiding by their own standards, their own clear standards. And this homeschool mom did a phenomenal job by remaining calm, standing on her God-given unalienable rights protected by the Constitution, and demanding that that deputy state the reason why she couldn't be there, and he didn't have an answer.
I'll tell you what's exciting. I want to get Joe Biggs' take on this when we come back and the state reps. You can feel the good people standing up in your gut. And they're so much stronger, so much more focused than these evil people. And evil knows it. That's why from Rutgers to the University of Texas, they're trying to restrict free speech because they know they got to shut us up. When we come back, we're going to fight back with the Second Amendment with Joe Biggs, Representative Matt Shea, VoteShea.com. And this sheriff's trying to organize movements to have Shea removed from office. We'll be back. You know, I'm going to move Vani Hari, the food babe, who's launching another major initiative and having huge success, to next week. Because what she's doing is very important, and we've got major GMO news where Germany is basically banning everything from the U.S. Russia is, because it's so polluted, it's so dangerous. And that's good. It'll stop big agra from doing what they're doing, voting with our dollars. Here it is. Germany joins Scotland in seeking ban on gene-modified seeds. So that's all coming up. We have Joel Salente the last 30 minutes, but I want to be able to get into this Planned Parenthood situation, the Chinese stocks, what's happening in Europe, where I see all this going. I want to get into this clip where comedian jabs Hillary Clinton for attending Bilderberg on national TV. This is very exciting what's happening, but I need to talk to Representative Shea and Joe Biggs for the rest of the hour to really be able to flesh all this out, and I appreciate them joining us. We're going to go back to them in a moment because I tend to start talking real fast. I start sweating. I start getting angry, not because there's something wrong with me. If I was a German in 1938 Germany, believe me, I'd be upset about what I saw. Military equipment being deployed locally, people being demonized for their free speech, restrictions on gathering if you weren't in the right group, kids being told their parents weren't their bosses. Classic totalitarianism. And I gotta say, Hitler's tyranny early on was focused mainly on select groups. It wasn't general. The general level of bizarreness with public schools all over the country banning touching hands, banning dodgeball, banning boy and girl, restricting free speech. Schools all across the country are, quote, banning all flags. See, all flags are hurtful now. All language is hurtful. That's the goal, where they can ban and restrict anything they want when they want. They're the arbiters who decide. These people are such tyrants that I get upset. I mean, when they're deploying armored vehicles in every town, and then police and military have told us for 18 years since I learned about this, from police and military, the chief of police of San Antonio, the head of emergency management in Kingsville, I have them on video saying Bill Clinton had Delta Force approach them about preparing martial law and gun confiscation. And by exposing that, they had to back off. They were thinking about pulling off more Oklahoma cities, folks, and blaming the Liberty Movement. But we exposed them. We backed them off. Now they're back, and it's like 10 times worse than it was. And they're openly saying, and we have another clip from Indiana we're going to play in a moment, saying this is for the American people. This is for the veterans. They're going to attack us. That's in Morgan County, Indiana, police sergeant saying the same words that we know came out of the mouth of the sheriff's deputy in Spokane, because it's Southern Poverty Law Center. And in their public documents, they say I'm evil and horrible and, you know, all this stuff. But in their internal ones, they say I'm a terrorist. We know that's come out. They were saying about locals that run mainline Tea Party groups that this is a terrorist. And imagine the sheriff deputies are all sitting there in a room, hundreds of them, learning in a major city, a major town, that this guy is a terrorist. So they see a woman out with her First Amendment. She's a terrorist. Now I'm going to give the floor to Joe Biggs and Shea for the rest of this segment and the last segment of this hour. But I've laid that out. We're going to play this clip. Briefly, I want to just remind viewers, it is essential that you spread the word about this broadcast. There is a reason they're attacking it. There is a reason they're demonizing it. Because we're here raising the alarm like Paul Revere. The exact same office Paul Revere had, we are in that position today. So is Matt Shea. So is people like Joe Biggs. So are you, like that woman out there with the pro-life sign. They want to intimidate us not to do that. That's why they tell us not to. Now, most departments would support it because they're good people. We have to expose the bad people that are globalist collaborators by engaging them peacefully. They want to get it violent because we're winning the info war. No, we've got hidden cameras inside your Planned Parenthood. We have hidden cameras inside your state houses. We're coming for you. We're stronger than you. There's more of us. We're awake now. We're coming. We're coming. Go ahead and act however you want. We're coming for you. I'm glad you're scared. We're coming. Go ahead. Engage in some terrorism. Blame us. This isn't 95. You're not going to get away with it. You didn't get away with 95. Most people know that was an inside job now. Go ahead. Try to pull it, because it's going to blow up in your face, literally. Before we go any further, we have the best colloidal silver out there, bar none. 30 parts per million, highest quality. I'm not going to sell out of it this time, because we're not going to get more until mid-October at least, maybe November. So I'm going to try to hold back enough so at regular sales price, we'll have enough to get us there. So I've done a calculation of selling it, how many we can sell until we need to stop the sale. Thursday or Friday, we'll have to end it guaranteed. Buy two bottles at regular price, get two bottles free, or get 30% off the regular discounted price. It's an amazing deal. Colloidal silver is so amazing. A lot of people know about it. Read about it at InfoWarsLife.com. Continuing, Super Male Vitality. After being sold out for weeks, Super Male Vitality is back in stock at InfoWarsLife.com. We are now taking orders on this new emergency shipment, our biggest shipment ever and the strongest. It has hundreds of five-star reviews on Power Reviews, third-party review site, highly respected. We link to it at InfoWarsLife.com. Here are just some of the latest reviews. This is by Inquiry, Miami, Florida. I feel a burst of energy within minutes. I use it in the morning after I get up to go to work and also take another before my daily workout routine in the afternoon. Wow, wow, wow. My power has increased when hitting the gym. I also started noticing that my muscles don't hurt as bad as they used to after hitting the gym hard. My muscle recovery has improved tremendously. Thank you, InfoWars. All your products are amazing. 1776. Okay, that's Miami, Florida. Thank you for the review. Thank you for your support. Power Lifter Dave. Initially didn't experience much in the way of results, so I held off writing a review. Then a little over a week ago, I began to notice some dramatic changes in how I felt and even in my mental state. This stuff is the real deal, and it varies the dose. I withheld a star because I want to see the long-term effects when things normalize within my body. But I would and do recommend this to my friends. Absolutely worth giving this a shot. Yeah. What it does is block estrogen mimickers. It gets your glands to start releasing. It doesn't mimic a testosterone. It gets your body to release a whole bunch of stuff, according to Group. I don't know the technicals. Read about it, InfoWarsLife.com. And it helps fund the operation, so it's a win-win. All right, I'm now going to try to settle down and shut up after this clip. Here is, again, what we mentioned, the sheriff's deputy there in the county in Indiana. The full video is on InfoWars.com, saying the exact same thing that the sheriff was saying out in Washington. Here it is.
We really didn't have the violence that we see today. The weaponry is totally different now than it was in the beginning of my career. Plus, you have a lot of people that are coming out of the military that have the ability and the knowledge to build IEDs and to defeat law enforcement techniques.
All right, Joe Biggs, you've been sitting back listening to all this. I want you to take a few minutes to break all this down. I mean, veterans, very low crime rate. Conservatives, one of the lowest crime rates. There isn't an escalation in patriots engaging in criminal activity or terrorism, but they're trying to prepare us for when they false flag, in my view. Go ahead.
I mean, just like that guy said, these guys are coming out of the military and they're automatically able to make these IEDs, which is complete and total BS. It'll only be a small portion of the people who actually train with explosive ordnance disposal or anything like that, or just some random stuff that you can figure out on the internet yourself. But they make it seem like you come back from Iraq and Afghanistan and you have this capability to go out and build these complex bombs and go blow stuff up. When in actuality, when you go over there, you learn how to restrain yourself. You learn how to use just different types of how you carry your weapon, where you point your muzzle, the safety with it, how you talk to people, how you approach, how you can de-escalate situations easier. My ability to de-escalate a situation is much easier than it is for a normal civilian who hasn't quite been through what I've been through. So when you see these sheriffs come out here and they say that we're just ticking time bombs, that's kind of just out of control right there. I mean, that's way out there.
Well, there are some that are ticking time bombs, but statistically, veterans have lower crime rates than any other major group. Well, it's just a load of crap.
The ones that are ticking time bombs are the ones that have been through a crazy scenario, such as like a lone survival thing. They bring them back and they pump them full of medications. They don't get to the root of the problem. They pump them full of medications.
Or they had something wrong with them before they went.
Yeah. But that's what they need to do. They need to get to the root of the problem. Stop demonizing an entire group of patriots who decided to get up off their butt and go fight for their country.
Well, they're getting ready to get rid of humans in combat and have all machines. And the last group the elite have to deal with is going to be the veterans. So there will be a major war on veterans worldwide. There's a war on men. There's a war on standing up. You know, Obama acts like he loves these soldiers that stood up on the train. They're all these heroes. That's exactly who they hate.
But they're using the mainstream media right now to dumb everybody down. I go all over the country and I meet people, engage in conversations. A lot of people don't even know they have the right to carry weapons. They don't even know that they could carry an assault rifle or a shotgun or what they even need to do to have a concealed weapon.
What do you think of this sheriff? What do you think he's doing?
I think he's just spewing rhetoric. I think he's out of control. I think this guy is a puppet for the SPLC. He's doing whatever he can to demonize the Patriot movement in Spokane. Like you said before, that's a great town full of great people. Everyone I met over there, good head on their shoulders, freedom-loving, liberty-loving Americans who want to do the right thing, and they don't want to live in a government that's going to try to take their land or pull them over in unmarked cars. They don't want to have to worry about stuff like that. They want to be normal Americans.
And now he's on the cover of the newspaper, standing on the people, standing on the county.
Yeah, that's,
I mean, it's bizarre. They clearly are trying to get somebody to do something.
Yeah, exactly. He's definitely.
And then I said, I'm coming out there to, you know, talk to the sheriff, and he starts tweeting, good, it's about time. And I'm like, man, this guy really, something's wrong with him.
Yeah, and I told him, I said, hey, make sure you don't go on vacation this time, because last time we went out there, we showed up under the police department. The guy was all of a sudden on this unexpected vacation that his apartment said had been planned for a while. But meanwhile, he'd been spotted all over town while we were there. He was just ducking and dodging us. So we'll see if he actually stands up this time and comes out and talks.
Well, we'd love to find out he was just wrong, but all right, I'm going to shut up now and go to Representative Matt Shea, VoteShea.com. I notice in the news articles they're saying these are horrible state reps that are with these extremists. We need to vote them out, and that's what the whole headline of the article says, that Spokane Republican sheriff says members of his own party are dangerously dividing people when he's the one doing it. Continue to break this down.
So there are a couple points here. First, I would like to also add that Sheriff Richard Mack challenged this sheriff to a debate. And this sheriff promised that at the beginning of the summer, he was going to have a debate with him. And it's been 8 months later, and he has still not followed up to debate Sheriff Richard Mack. So it's just a continued pattern of behavior by this guy to say one thing and then do something completely different. The other point that I would like to make as far as this is concerned, what we're really talking about when we talk about Planned Parenthood, we talk about this veteran that was being threatened, at least his firearms rights were being threatened up there in Priest River, Idaho. They want us to self-censor. They're trying to make the environment so toxic out there that we just self-censor. And that is the worst kind of tyranny. And that's what really, I think, ultimately they are trying to do. This sheriff is directly related to FEMA. And boy, he's acting like it. Many of his statements are, oh, the government's doing a great job. Tell that to the people up in North Central Washington right now, where we had the Forest Service refuse to put a fire out when it was only an acre, and it grew to thousands of acres and has destroyed dozens of cattle up there on one ranch in particular. So really, there's this disconnect, I think, between these people that are defending the bureaucracy and the rest of America. This sheriff says we need to vote these representatives out of office, and yet, because I stand on principle, because I expose this stuff, and these other legislators that work with me over in Olympia expose this stuff, and we fight it, and we stand on that line. That's what the people want, and we keep getting reelected by huge numbers, no matter how much money they throw against us.
That's right. You and others, I was reading, you've had the Bloomberg anti-gun money coming into the state against you. You've got the Southern Poverty Law Center sneaking around. You've got the media demonizing you, but all that does is make you more popular. What do you think that tells the sheriff?
Well, I think it scares the sheriff, and that's what's making him so nervous. That's what's making him become unhinged like he is right now. And when government is fearing the people, that's actually a good thing. Mm-hmm. It is a good thing. That's what freedom is. That's what freedom looks like. And I don't know, you know, going to some place over on the west side, downtown Seattle, if they're going to feel the same way I do about this. But many people in rural Washington and in eastern Washington do feel this way, that bureaucrats are literally becoming little petty tyrants. And we're really experiencing bureaucratic terrorism. And people are sick and tired of being guilty until proven innocent. And the way that this sheriff's been acting, especially toward constitutionalists, and especially calling them out on several occasions, is clearly fostering that feeling. And one recent incident, and this has not been widely reported on, there was a gentleman who is very well versed on his constitutional obligations and his God-given unalienable rights protected by the Constitution. And he stood, just like this homeschool mother did in this Planned Parenthood video, and said, tell me why you are questioning us. Are we free to leave? Are we being detained? Well, he ended up getting arrested. He gets taken downtown. He's sitting there getting booked. And one of the first things that's said to him is, you're one of those constitutionalists, aren't you? And that's the attitude that is pervasive throughout this department. They try to say these things are taken out of context, when in reality, this is exactly what they're being trained on.
It's incredibly creepy to see them doing this. And it's all because of Agenda 21. It's all the new zoning, all the new regulations. It's preparing the police and the military for this tyrannical agenda. And the agenda's admitted. It's in the news. They just don't want us speaking out against it because the agenda is so unpopular. I see the people across the political spectrum really starting to awaken. Representative Shea, what would you say the sense is of your constituents about what's happening?
The sense is exactly what you're saying, that something is drastically wrong in this country, that we are headed in the exact wrong direction, that tyranny is dramatically increasing, especially over the last 2 months. People before that said, oh, that would never happen in America, are now saying, oh my goodness, you were right. InfoWars was right. What do I do? So there is a great awakening happening right now. And just that one incident up there in Priest River where the VA was threatening the firearms rights of that veteran, on one post, we had 760 Facebook shares, literally went viral in a matter of hours. And I think that is a testimony to the fact that people are waking up. And not only waking up, they're ready to get engaged and stand on the line and say, enough, no more. You've gone too far. You need to back up and get back in your constitutionally designed box.
That's right. They're always trying to intimidate us. They're always trying to shut us up. They're always trying to make us think we don't have power. But there's a time in history when people finally go across a line. They don't care what the enemy says or what's done or what's in front of them. They're going to find a way to expose it. They're engaged. They're motivated. Nothing's going to stop them. And I can feel that energy rising. I had dread just a few months ago seeing all this corruption expand. But now I can see it and also feel it. Just like in a football game, you feel the momentum change when you're in the stands. I can feel the spirit of liberty exploding. Can you feel it, Joe?
Of course. Everywhere I go, I can feel it. You see it when you talk to people. When people engage in conversation with you, you can tell that there's a great awakening happening and we're going to start winning.
And they're not afraid. They know that they just got to get up off their butt, start speaking out, and they don't care win or lose. They're not going to shut up. Final segment with our special guest. Representative Matt Shea from Washington State will be with us with Joe Biggs 5 minutes to the next hour. Then we're going to get into the abortion situation and so much more. But this new video put together that illustrates reality and fiction together, how Red Dawn is beginning to parallel what America is becoming like. It's like a Red Dawn in slow motion. Darren McBreen and, of course, Rob Dew put this together last week. I thought I'd play it now and then get the representative's take on it. If you're a radio listener, it's even more powerful as video. So go to Infowars.com/show. We're also going to post the video itself to YouTube today and post it to Infowars.com in the next hour. But here is that Red Dawn parallel.
It's 11:59 at Radio Free America. This is Uncle Sam with music and the truth until dawn. Right now, I got a few words for some of our brothers and sisters in the occupied zone. The chair is against the wall. The chair is against the wall. John has a long mustache. John has a long mustache. It's 12 o'clock, Americans, another day closer to victory. And for all of you out there on or behind the lines, this is your song.
But they took a lot of people away. People that they thought were going to make trouble for them. People that had guns or things they wanted, they just took them away.
Where?
Re-education camps, that's what they call it.
So part of it is we have to break through our kind of private idea that kids belong to their parents, or kids belong to their families, and recognize that kids belong to whole communities.
I have decided we really need camps for adults. And we need the kind of camps that you all
All persons of Japanese descent were required to register. Now they were taken to racetracks and fairgrounds where the Army almost overnight had built assembly centers.
Come on. I'm a sovereign citizen. I refuse to recognize you guys.
What kind of a situation in the U.S. would you see that happening?
I mean, we've got a lot of constitutionalists, a lot of people that stockpile weapons.
Plus, you have a lot of people that are coming out of the military that have the ability and the knowledge to build IEDs and to defeat law enforcement techniques.
These people are radicalized and they don't support the United States and they're disloyal to the United States. It's our right and our obligation to segregate them from the normal community.
And so what we're doing here, and let's not kid about it, we're building a domestic army because the government is afraid of its own citizens.
Put your gun down, really?
Rallying patriots worldwide in defense of human liberty. It's Alex Jones.
Are you some kind of a constitutionalist?
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.
See, that's my response is, oh my God, like a foreign enemy is attacking. I see the manuals, the training. We got them first from secret sources, as everybody knows, 7 years ago. And they're preparing for war with us. Representative Shea, we've got a few minutes to break. We're going to come back and finish up. But, I mean, isn't that the key to this, that they don't want to have a debate about the treasonous, traitorous preparations that are being made, that our own military doesn't want to follow? And that's really what's backfired, is the military is so awake now because they're trying to train them to take on their grandfather and their father, who are a veteran. I mean, this is really backfire. Can you speak to that briefly?
Absolutely. The Oath Keepers in the military are alive and well. The spirit of 76 is alive and well. And I would just comment on the one part of the video. We're disloyal to tyrants. We're disloyal to tyranny. We are loyal to America. We're loyal to the Constitution. And we believe the Constitution means what it says. And what they try to do is deflect, obfuscate, divagle, get people pointed in every direction except what they're actually doing.
Exactly, because they are literally collaborators that have taken over the country. I mean, they are an occupation force. That's not rhetoric, folks.
Thank you for listening to GCN.
They're trying to ban the word boy and girl. Back in 70 seconds. Representative Shea, finish up. All right, Representative Shea, you got cut off by the break there. You were talking about the open preparation for war with the American people. They call us traitors. I mean, I can't believe that they've got the nerve to try this, but they're really doing it. Where do you see all this going?
Well, you don't build a surveillance state unless you intend to use it. You don't give MRAPs and bayonets to local law enforcement unless you intend to use them. You don't try to shut off all dissent, shut off all questioning, unless you want the people to self-censor under that tyranny. You don't do that. You don't build all these constructs unless you intend to use them. And I've said that in many speeches, and I think that resonates with people because they see what's going on before their eyes. Whether we're talking, you know, all of the things going on with cameras and surveillance and all of that, or we're talking about this sheriff trying to demonize one group of people. And what's alarming to me is that when you look back through history, that demonization comes very, very closely on the heels of persecution.
And the persecution's already started.
It has already started. Take for example, the baker in Oregon or the photographer in New Mexico. Just because they can't do something according to their conscience, they suddenly are the enemy. In fact, there's a case here in Washington State with the Stormans family. They don't want to stock a Plan B abortion pill on their shelves. And they have had to spend $3 million fighting the government in that case.
Listen, I live in Travis County, and this is the only county in Texas where I have to pay for people's abortions. That's not right. Or sex changes. Since when do I have to be your slave and pay for everything?
That's exactly right. That doesn't even make sense in the American paradigm. We have an absolute, in Washington State's Constitution, it recognizes an absolute freedom of conscience in all matters of religious sentiment under Article 1. Section 10, then also in Article 26.
That's why we said reason of conscience federally, do not join the military. That should stand up. I mean, since when does the right to say no stand?
It's exactly right. Here's the bigger problem. If we can't have the right of conscience, if we can't have freedom of thought, then we don't have freedom at all. That's why I believe the founders put that as in the First Amendment in the Bill of Rights,
yep,
and then followed it immediately up by the Second, because one cannot be absent without the other.
Well, that's why California just passed that law, getting rid of the conscience exemption for vaccines. They're saying, you're not allowed to say no. We don't recognize your intellect. We're God.
That's exactly right. That's why it was so important and I think was so encouraging to watch what happened up in Priest River, Idaho, with that veteran and the VA trying to threaten his firearms rights. And you had a bunch of patriots and the county sheriff show up armed, but very peaceful and very firm, that they were not going to take away any of his firearms. And guess what happened? The government backed down. And that happens in almost every situation where we the people stand up peacefully, but armed, and we stand on our rights and say no further, they back down. And Alex, that is why it is so important for any legislator to wear like the Spirit of 76 pin. And that's one of the reasons I proudly wear it over there in Olympia, because everybody needs to know that is the spirit we need to get back to.
What kind of support are you getting to get Sheriff Ozzie Nezevich out of office?
We're getting a ton of support, actually. Radio, local radio personalities are highlighting the issue right now. There's been a petition drive that has received hundreds, if not thousands, of signatures at this point to remove him from office. And we're continuing to pursue this. And as people are seeing what this sheriff is doing, they are very disturbed by it. And it's waking them up as well. And they're getting involved.
Well, that's what tyrants do. They always push it too far. We just need to keep this peaceful. Notice they keep saying we're threatening them because that's all they can do is lie. And I give you this promise, Representative Shea, either late this year or next year, I will, early next year, maybe even sooner, I will get out there, but mainly to go talk to these great sheriffs, but we'll also go do a demonstration. I know your office is right across the street from the sheriff's office, and just point out that we know they're being prepared by foreign agents for war against the people. Thank you, Representative Shea. New video, Planned Parenthood video, baby parts buyer jokes about shipping severed heads. And the Weekly Standard has the transcript of that. We focused on Infowars.com on another part of the quote, joking about needing 50 livers a week and saying sometimes it's just blood clots. What are they climbing out of the dishes on their own? I mean, it's a long video because they're not putting these out edited. Some of these videos are 5-6 hours long. And I mean, you sit there and you watch them always drinking wine, giggling, snickering, making fun of the dead babies. Truly disgusting. Meanwhile, Lindsey Graham says Trump's immigration plan is stupid and illegal. You'd expect that from a traitor like Lindsey Graham. Rutgers quietly removes no such thing as free speech from their student manual. I mean, talk about re-education camp. Talk about tyranny. Give up already. Almost half of Americans say Hillary should halt presidential campaign. New video. Again, Planned Parenthood baby parts buyer asks for another 50 livers per week. U.S. Protects Afghan opium fields from Taliban attack. Trump says Chinese economic crisis could lead to depression. No kidding. It's time to kick prepping into overdrive because the stock market crash is just the beginning. And Chinese market crash again in biggest collapse in 20 years, but the Federal Reserve props up the stock market here. And that's why it's so dangerous, because it's artificial. And the Federal Reserve is using basically U.S. tax money that we got to pay for later to pump up stocks that then only helps the people that own the stocks. And it basically picks winners is why it's such a problem. But I wanted for TV viewers, I'll describe it for radio listeners, to play a few clips, just the video, from that Red Dawn piece that we released last week. Because when you look at them in the re-education camp, and we play clips of Hillary and clips of other people on MSNBC saying your kids don't belong to you, you have to understand, we have an Army manual that came out 2 years ago that we can put on screen right now at army.mil, where in the article, it openly states, and again, it links to the document. I pulled it up during the break with Nico, so it's right there on that computer, where it says re-education camp for the American people. And it talks about our Social Security numbers, how to process us. This is the ultimate smoking gun article. Yes, the re-education camp manual does apply domestically to U.S. citizens. It says it more than 20 times in the manual. And you can link to it for yourself, and how the PSYOP teams are going to brainwash the public, control the local political leaders, and do all this. And this is what Jade Helm is about in their own admissions, is mastering the human domain. Then we play some of the background video for TV viewers of the re-education camp. And then in Red Dawn, it cuts to some of the young high school students freaking out as they actually see war come to their shores, and they can't believe it. But at least they're upset by it and resist it. That's how we are, folks. I get freaked out every time I see the video, I see the documents, I see the training, I hear the announcements with classical tyranny being brought forward and the government preparing for war with us. It is so ridiculous. Joe Biggs, final comments.
Well, I mean, you see it subliminally being dropped in video games as well. I play a lot of games from time to time, combat games, and all you see in the background are FEMA camp signs. You see these camps where there's people behind the barbed wire, like a Call of Duty Advanced Warfighter. You see the exact same stuff like you saw in Red Dawn, where there's these FEMA trailers everywhere, and the whole place is just ransacked, and people are in camps, and you're sitting there fighting with this tyrannical government. I mean, it's crazy, and they're dropping it little by little in all these different games to kind of slowly get into the people's mind. There's something to accept.
And see, some people exactly would say, oh, good, patriots are inside the video game makers, and they're trying to warn us. Well, some of them are, but the elite are allowing that to come out because they actually want to start a physical civil war. They want people to get the idea to go out and be part of this, Joe.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, the way that they're hinting at it nonstop, and the fact that you can see the dumbing down of people, like the people just don't even know their rights, it's mind-blowing, because when it gets to a point where they actually do want to implement something like that, it'll be so easy for them to, because there's just a lot of people out there that don't even know what it is that they can and can't do.
Do you think the sheriff has been put up to trying to bait? You've said yes, but I mean, do you think specifically the Southern Poverty Law Center has gone in there and done this? They've done it before.
I mean, with his track record, I don't see why not. I mean, it looks like it could be one of those things where he just wants to get people riled up and then they can use it to usher in something. I mean, the way that the SPLC is coming in there, I don't know. I don't trust the guy one bit at all.
When do you think that he can be voted out of office? When is the...
That personally, I don't know. But like you said, they have a lot of support to get him out of office. And I've met a lot of people in Spokane, and most people I've met out there are very passionate about getting that man out of office and getting someone new in there.
Well, that's the answer to the situation.
Like I said, that MRAP I saw was the biggest MRAP I had ever seen. When Josh and I stood there beside that, and we were actually invited in there to look at that, that thing is ginormous.
Yeah, we have the footage.
I don't even know what you would need that for here. That is so over the top.
What was the name of that video last year? We can pull it up whenever you went and showed the MRAP. InfoWars Tours MRAP, or what was it?
Yeah, Spokane MRAP or Spokane Tank, something like that. Josh is back there right now. But yeah, I mean, that when I saw it, I was in complete and total awe. Much larger than anything I had ever seen in combat that the U.S. Army used. It was so bulky and giant. Yeah, that's going to scare people. When you pull up and say you're here to help me in that vehicle, sorry, but I'm not going to feel like I'm safe at all whatsoever.
Well, they're the same armored vehicles they have in Hunger Games. They actually use those vehicles in the Hunger Games for a dystopic world.
It is a dystopic world we're in right now. I
mean, and then we sit here and we talk about it and they laugh. Hey, a quick InfoWarsLife.com story. You flew up with a buddy on a private single-engine plane, I guess, up to Georgia to be part of another head-down event. You said you were flying back and stopped for some gas at a small airport and ran into somebody that didn't even listen to the show but had the products. Tell folks that story.
Yeah, so I was flying into, it's called the Silver Comet Airport in Paulding County, Georgia. And I landed, and there's this guy standing out there like a red carpet. I guess they do that for every little plane that pulls up. And he rolls it out. I was like, oh, this is so neat.
You know? A nice gimmick, yeah.
Yeah. So I get out, and this guy goes, oh, my God. He says, InfoWars, right? He's like, I've seen you on the store site. And I said, oh, yeah? And he goes, yeah, come inside really quick. So he runs me inside, and he's all excited. He has his whole family line up in this little tiny airport, and they lay out the Super Male Vitality, the Super Female, the X2, the Silver, the Colloidal Silver, everything. And I said, wow, I was like, you're a listener of the show? He goes, I didn't even know you guys had a show. He says, the local fire department and police department over here, they always bring me over these samples. And then they gave me a link to the store, so I just go in there all the time.
But see how it's police and firefighters that are awake. That's why Soros wants to get a war going with them, because we can show bad examples of cops all day. And sure, it goes viral and it's entertaining to just blame them. But they're more awake on average than the general public. They're allies of the country on average. We don't want to have a civil war with them. Right there. It's the police and the fire department giving it to them and turning folks onto the show.
I've got a lot of friends who are in bands like the Damn Quails. These guys tour all over the country. And all they do is you'll see them on stage taking the Super Male Vitality. They'll flip their guitar up and they'll have the InfoWars.com sticker on there.
What great listeners.
And they go out and they promote it and they give it to people and talk about it. And everyone loves it. I've got nothing but great feedback. Even when I walk through the airport, people will be like, Super Male Vitality, and they'll yell at me and put their fists up in the air. I'm like, all right, man, right on.
Well, the product really does work good and doesn't have the bad side effects, because I took some Yohimbe in college working out with some really big guys to see what they'll do, and I got bigger. I was on it about a month, this root. I guess it has testosterone, but the Wavos got a little smaller, and I got really grumpy, and I had headaches and, like, hot flashes. None of that happens on Super Male Vitality. No. You've been taking it. What do you think?
Yeah, yeah. Like I said, I remember the first day I took it. I mean, the reaction is different for everyone, but I honestly remember feeling like this boost of energy immediately within about 30 to 45 minutes. I was kind of like, huh. And I was like, I think.
I'll be honest. It does make me become a jerk if I take too much.
Yeah.
And so that's why I used to take half the dose. Now I've built up to taking a full dose. But it's the real deal, and it funds the operation.
I take that, and I also have the colloidal silver. I take that a good bit. I went to Hawaii on vacation not too long ago, and everyone out there had colloidal silver and Super Male Vitality. I kid you not. Whenever I went somewhere, someone stopped me. They would go home and be like, hey, I just need to go down to my house real quick. They come back, and they pull it out of their purse or their pocket just to show me that they were supporting the show and that they had been buying this product. So I thought that was really interesting.
It's incredible. And if folks continue to do that, we're going to be able to really expand the operation, get more reporters, get more writers. I mean, right now we've just spent a ton of money with the new studio, the satellite systems, all of that. So know this, folks, you're really helping us fight the globalist, and we really appreciate your support. But plus, you're getting amazing products. For women, it has... Look, I didn't go out and get this product to be an aphrodisiac or to be... a libido deal. But I will tell you this. Well, I just wanted to see, because the doctor I went to said, hey, do you want a thing for Cialis or Viagra? And I said, yeah, since I was already using Super Male. They're not as good. Not that I even need it. 75% of the use of that's recreational. And I don't mean to get details, but we're adults here, folks. We're being honest about this. Super Male is not something that we... are pitching in that direction, but that's the first thing I noticed the day after I took it.
Oh, yeah. I will have to concur on that one.
Now, Joe, you're not married. You're not allowed to be involved in any of this. Anyways, no, but what about stamina working out? I noticed you've lost some weight.
Yeah, I mean, I'm doing a lot of, trying to do more cardio, but it's hard. Like I said, I've been trying to get surgery on my knee and my foot for
some time. The VA won't do it?
It takes forever. You go in, you see a doctor, and then there's a new doctor there the next week, and then there's a new doctor the next time you go in, and you just have to re-explain your situation. It's just a long, drawn-out process.
Well, we appreciate all the folks out there. God bless you. We'll be back with that clip of the comedian basically exposing Bilderberg on the Conan O'Brien broadcast. That's a big deal because these shows are so censored. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Infowars.com. What I was getting at earlier, most of you probably got, but I didn't boil it down that simply. I get convoluted because I'm really just stream of consciousness on air. The opposite of teleprompter or talking points. It's fantastical that the government's been taken over by foreign interest, that the Chinese are the second largest owners of our debt, the Chinese communists, that the Panama Canal was handed over, that we've been maneuvered into the end of our sovereignty, just like the United Kingdom. And that now they've got the police and military training to take on gun owners and veterans as the number one enemy. And I know I harp on that because harping on it will expose it before they trigger the events that give them the pretext to take over. I mean, these folks want to arrest a woman with no criminal record holding up a pro-life sign, part of a nationwide protest. That's called dirtbag behavior. I wouldn't arrest a person with a hammer and sickle, even though I hate it, because I've got to defend their right or we'll lose it all. I mean, how do you get sheriff deputies to act like this? They're led by a scumbag. A lying scumbag. And I'm just going to talk like that because I realize there's no way to be a gentleman with somebody like this. I have people on here for, quote, debates. I try to be gentlemanly. And then it's implied that, I lost the debate because I wasn't aggressive or mean and let somebody talk. That's what people want, is they just want to all be nasty, I guess. Because I wish this sheriff would be a patriot, but he's not. He's trampling people's rights. They're preparing to take the guns of Social Security recipients. Days after we reported on it, it was mainstream news. Do you understand? They, with a straight face, get on TV and in the newspapers, and talk about, yeah, we're looking at using the same formula the VA has that's secret to take the guns of Social Security recipients. One thing the FBI says, if you take a money transfer, That means you're incompetent. And they just talk about it with a straight face. People go, oh, okay. And yeah, we sell living babies. You know, we dissect them. And we sell their organs. And we got dead kids in the basement. You know, it's... And flying saucers landed in Times Square. I mean, it's all over the top. And people need to just break out of the trance and go, man, this is weird. This is crazy that MRAPs are being delivered and they're training at the ROTCs all over the country to fight the militias. And that's just going to be people that run to the hills that don't want to be drug off to a FEMA camp. By the way, I feel sorry for the military. They're going to try to march a bunch of 18 and 19 and 20-year-old young men off to fight 30, 40, 50, 60-year-old, 70-year-old veterans who don't, who aren't scared to die. I mean, I really feel sorry for the people that, I mean, the best of the best in this country are going to fight back. And I just really feel sorry for anybody maneuvered into a civil war with the liberty movement in this country. It's the most vicious fighting force the world's ever seen. It'll make the Iraqis look like little angel cakes. It'll make the Russians look tame. Basically, the New World Order starting a fight with the Patriots is like Hitler starting a fight with the Russians, but worse. I mean, the gloves actually come off. You people are going to be in serious trouble very quickly. Mark Kornke has the best allegory for it. He's absolutely right. It's like up north, they have moose hunting licenses, but there's so few moose, you've got to go be part of a lottery, and maybe one out of 10 people that enter the lottery on average, it's kind of like a mountain lion lottery or whatever in Texas, maybe one out of 10 will actually get the ticket to get the license to hunt the moose. And if there is a civil war, being a New World Order operative, being a minion, being an enforcer is going to be like being a moose in moose hunting season. If the Patriots come after you. I'm just telling you, your bosses are trying to get you into something. It's just, whew, feel sorry for you. That's all I can say. And I don't want a civil war. I'm not telling you this to sound big and sound strong. The liberty movement is strong, and you know it. We're the enemy of the world government. We got the whole world government breathing down our neck because we're one of the last countries that hadn't been disarmed yet. Let's go to this video of the comedian jabbing Hillary on Conan O'Brien, Bill Burr, who the crew's a big fan of, obviously telling it like it is. Here's the clip.
Donald Trump, do you think a businessman like Trump has a chance to be president? Do you think he has any shot at all? Do you think this is real?
No, just because no one would work with him. Like, Republicans and Democrats would be babies, and they would pout because they're, like, bought and owned. And it's like, how come this guy's free
right,
and gets to say whatever he wants? I mean, I don't know. I've enjoyed the hell out of him, just all the stuff the guy's been saying. I hope more politicians are just at least just say what they're thinking.
Right.
I love when they were going like, yeah, you said all this sexist stuff about women. You said this about
women. We're going to come back and play the whole clip.
Women. You said this, and he goes,
because that's the long version. I was going to play just a short clip about Hillary, but we're going to come back and play the whole thing. See, Trump gives people the courage to speak their mind. As more of us
we're
do it, it's game over.
The empire is on the run.
We're coming for you.
Alex Jones and the
Either
GCN
way,
Radio Network.
We are destroying you. People out there want to know how to be successful in media. You need to have passion. You need to have history. You need to have a will to tell it like it is, even if you get demonized and attacked for it. And whether you're always right or always wrong, whatever, people want to hear from folks that are authentic. And it's the authentic people historically that are right 9 times out of 10. Because we're trying to be honest. We're not trying to spin things. I feel sorry for the liars, the teleprompter readers, the prostitutes that Gerald Celente calls them because their job is rough. Here's that clip I was mentioning. Comedian jabs Hillary Clinton for attending Bilderberg on national TV. And in context, he was serious, attacking both political parties as basically being a mafia. Comedian and actor Bill Burr called out presidential candidate Hillary Clinton. Here is that clip.
Absolutely. I mean, I don't think it matters who's president. I'm one of those people. I don't think it matters.
Doesn't matter at all.
Dude, Hillary Clinton goes to those Bilderberg meetings. That's like the Illuminati stuff, right? She probably hooked up with some guy wearing like a goat's head, and then she goes out on TV, and she's talking to people who drive snowplows, like she can relate to them.
Going to Gerald Celente, who's got his new op-ed editorial in the USA Today today. World sinks deep into recession, opposing view. We've also got a clip of him a while back basically predicting now what's unfolding. I predict that you're going to see the stock market in the next few weeks go right back down to new lows. They've just gone in and used the President's Open Market Committee, the Plunge Protection Team, to pump it back up. We're going to get Joel Salente's take on that here in just a moment. Please don't forget, we have the highest quality water filtration systems, the lowest prices, like the Pro Pure G2 system that cuts out the glyphosates, the fluoride, you name it. We have the side-by-side comparisons from top third-party labs in the country about how we annihilate the competition. If the competition was anywhere near it, I would just carry all their stuff too, because I'm all about carrying the biggest selection. We carry Pro Pure, Life Straw for emergency situations, and a couple other systems that are even more affordable, but just massively reduce everything. They don't completely cut out a bunch of stuff. But when you're cutting out 99% of something, it's pretty much the same thing. But we've got what stuff I use in my house, the stuff I use when I'm on vacation, when I'm traveling. I mean, we set out to really do 2 years of research. We didn't sell water filters. You notice I just stopped selling water filters because I got fed up. I mean, I will not sell something unless I've really researched it and believe in it. 10% off promo code WATER continually, InfoWarsStore.com, a subsection of InfoWarsStore.com. You see the taste test videos, the scientific studies, all of it that is right there on the site. So it is very important to shop with the good guys, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. InfoWarsStore.com is the books, the videos, the T-shirts, the ball caps, the shortwave radios, the cook stoves, the non-GMO seeds, and hundreds of other items, the dash cams, the not-made-in-America apparel. But InfoWarsLife.com has the high-quality nutraceuticals, madein1776.com, has all the apparel made in America, if you should so choose to purchase in that way. So this is how we fund the operation. I salute you, and I thank you, Prostaguard, and so many other great products at InfoWarsLife.com. And we will stop selling the colloidal silver at the buy two, get two free when we run out to a certain level. And then I'm going to keep what we've got left because it's going to be until middle of October till we get more colloidal silver. If I sell out, I'm going to keep some back at the regular sales rate so that we never sell out. Now, that's what I'm going to start doing, is not discounting things if I'm unable to, because that frustrates people not being able to get it. So take advantage of that now, InfoWarsLife.com. And again, Gerald would already be on with us. His Skype dropped a while back. We're trying to reconnect with him, so that's why I'm here basically babbling around and motor-mouthing. I'm happy to get Gerald on via phone if we're having issues. So we can just abort Skype and just get him on phone. Okay, continuing here with some of the news that we need to get into. Hillary Clinton is in big trouble. The Democrats are openly getting ready to run Joe Biden. Obama gives Biden his blessing to mull White House run. This story is from CBS Washington, and the word is Obama is basically letting the Justice Department go after Hillary enough to not actually prosecute her, but to wound her so that the Obama dynasty can go on with its puppets like Biden instead of Obama being a puppet of the Clintons. So he's basically Clintoning the Clintons with what they did to him, so that his crew of rats can go into the future staying in power. Because it is the Clintons that basically, to a great degree, controlled Obama. They wanted Hillary, but he was more popular, so they allowed him to get in. And now that double-crossing is going on. Speaking of China, Asia's richest man loses $3.6 billion on China's Black Monday as world's billionaires see their fortunes tumble. Wang Jianlin saw U.S. $2 billion wiped from his stake in Dalian Wanda Commercial Properties. Again, Asia's richest person loses $3.6 billion alone yesterday. Their markets were, again, down massively today. Chinese rate cut not enough to dispel concerns. U.S. stocks jump at the open and continue on. We'll put up CNBC for folks and give them some of the current numbers there. Let's continue here with some of the other news about what's been happening with the economy. Chinese markets crash again in biggest collapse in 20 years. The key Shanghai Composite Index sank another 7.63 today, extending its worst rout. So again, what happened with our stock market? Well, they admit it now. They went in with the plunge protection team and pumped it up. We do have Gerald Celente now, and I want to play a clip from Gerald Celente, and we'll give you the date in a moment, predicting what's now happening to the Dow, and he'll give us his further projections now that we've gotten a lot closer to the bubble completely imploding. And, of course, Mr. Dent was also on with us 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, and predicted that this would start within 2 weeks and pretty much nailed it directly. Here is the Gerald Celente clip.
Hi, this is Gerald Celente. Wednesday, April 23rd, 2014, and here are some of today's trends in the news. The markets, well, everything is kind of flat today. Gold is flat. The markets are flat. Earl is flat and coming down a little bit. But the prices of the pump are going up. It's springtime. People drive more. Got to get them prices up. Hey. And here's the fact. U.S. middle class is no longer world's richest. No kidding. Wow.
Well, Gerald, better late than never. I heard your power went off, but we're glad you're here via telephone. Gerald Celente, is this the beginning of the implosion of the bubble?
Yes. Actually, on August 6th, there's another tape. It's on YouTube as well. I came out and said that the markets were going to crash before the end of the year, and sooner rather than later. It was a Trends in the News broadcast. What people are missing, Alex, is you pick up the headlines and they're all blaming China, China's economic woes. Even Trump came out blaming China. It's not China. It's the global slowdown. China is the canary in the global equity mine. And I've said this over and over again. If Americans and Europeans don't buy things, the Chinese don't make them. If the Chinese don't make them, all those natural resource-rich countries, Australia, Venezuela, Russia, Chile, Bolivia, they're not, and on, Canada, they're not exporting their raw materials. It's a global slowdown. When I was on your show 2 weeks ago, the Bloomberg Commodity Index was down to 13-year lows. It is now down to 16-year lows. With that, you're seeing the currencies of all of these natural resource-rich countries plummeting one after another. So what you have is you have, for example, the ruble. It's down to its 2015 lows against the dollar. It was trading at something like, 36 rubles to a dollar. Now it's 70-something. It's one after another. And by the way, what happened is we have a whole blackout in the city of Kingston. That's why we went off the air so quick. And our phone lines are down as well. So we're doing this over a cell phone. So what we're looking at, Alex, is a complete commodities crash, a complete currency crash. It has nothing to do with China, but it's easy to pick out an enemy, so let's make it China. And as you pointed out, Chinese markets are continuing to crash. This is after unprecedented schemes to prop up their failing Shanghai index, prohibiting short selling. You'll go to jail or we'll shoot you, maybe if we don't take you to jail. You cannot sell your grade A stocks for 6 months. We're dumping in over $200 billion to prop the markets up, and it's still not working. Their real estate bubble has collapsed. This is the world's second largest economy. Look at the Nikkei index. Look at the yen. And it's not a question of the Chinese devaluing their yuan lower so they could export more. The yen is completely devalued, and you're looking at Japanese exports down. The people have no money. That's why they're not buying things. That's why China's not making them. And that's why there's a global equity market crash. And what they're not talking about, and this is very important, when the quantitative easing scheme happened, they funneled the world with cheap dough. All these emerging markets borrow this money for next to nothing. Now these emerging markets' economies are collapsing because of commodity prices collapsing, their currencies are collapsing, and guess what? This is barely reported. Over $9 trillion of bond buying between of companies and countries in these emerging markets has come from the United States, not from the government, not from the banks, but from mutual funds, from Templeton, from BlackRock, from PIMCO. So now you have all these declining economies. You have their currencies devalued, and their debt is owed in dollars. So now they can't even pay it back, and they can't raise interest rates to prop up their currencies because their economies are collapsing. So if you make interest rates higher, things only get worse.
And now the Federal Reserve is signaling that they may lower rates more. How can they lower rates more when it's already at zero for the big private banks? Of course, not zero for the people. A, B, Gerald, what do you expect to see in the next few weeks? They were able to pump up the U.S. stock market today. Don't you expect that to start going down just like the Chinese one did?
Well, of course, at some point. But again, you know, this is, you know, people better stop calling this capitalism. It's fascism. It's the merger of state and corporate powers. If you or I don't do good business, you don't see them bailing us out or playing games. They do this to protect their buddies.
So they might do like Zimbabwe and just say the stock market's at $5 billion or something. I mean, they could just start putting any number they want on it.
Exactly. So what will they do? You mentioned the plunge protection team. They'll do anything they can to prop it up. Here is what we're seeing. And this is what we believe is going to happen. You know I have the track record for this. Make sure you have your money in your hands. You talked about Zimbabwe currency devaluations. Because if you don't have your money, you don't own it. You saw what happened to me with MF Global. You saw what happened to me. I wrote about it when I tried to make large withdrawals out of banks, HSBC and Key Bank. Those are the names I wrote about it. They refused to give me my money. I had to go through a lot of.
Look at Greece. Look at other countries. Look at capital controls now coming in Spain. They're gearing up for it.
And look at Cyprus and look on and on. So if you don't have your money in your pocket, you don't own it. Number two, watch for violent crime. You could even see it. It's increasing already. You know my line. When people lose everything and have nothing left to lose, they lose it. And with that, you're going to see more racial tensions because there's going to be finger pointing. The other one to look at, and you can see it going on around the world, they call it migration in Europe. It's immigration in the United States. I mentioned what's going on in these countries with devalued currencies and crashing commodity prices. Whether it's Ghana or whether it's Chile, whether it's Colombia or whether it's Venezuela, whether it's Angola or Nigeria, all of these countries are barely making it when things were going well. You're going to see floods of people leaving their countries trying to find a place to make a buck. And on top of that, the wonderful wars brought to us by Obama, Bush, Clinton, and you look at the pictures of the people running into Macedonia and breaking over the borders. Read the words where they're from. They're from Afghanistan. They're from Yemen. They're from Iraq, and they're from Libya, and that's what's going on, and Syria, because of the United States wars.
And meanwhile, the government's getting armored vehicles, preparing to use them on the Tea Party and veterans, and they're openly announcing that cash should be illegal, and they should take our money out of our accounts, and you shouldn't be able to leave the country with money. You can see them getting ready for this while they tell us not to get ready. and that we're conspiracy theorists if we care. And then Obama is advertising immigrants who are unskilled to come here and have their anchor babies. What do you think the master plan is there, A, and then B, much more important? Gerald, you've been very accurate so far. What do you see next? Because I know you couldn't tell how the breaks would be exactly. But now that we're closer to it, how do you expect this meltdown to unroll? Because the reason I started saying a year ago, I now believe it's imminent, is because I talked to a lot of high-powered people like you do. It was also in the news that there's a major exodus to armored fortresses, armored redoubts, offshore bases, New Zealand, bunkers in the Ozarks, bunkers in the middle of the Canadian wilderness. I mean, the elite are pulling out of Dodge. Go ahead.
Well, you got it. And that's what I'm saying. As we see more violence, as we see more tensions, they're going to do everything they can to break down the people. And then what they're going to do, just like they're blaming China on this, they're going to find a scapegoat. And it may be a false flag or real, but you're going to see one. And it's going to happen. So what we're saying is that's how they're going to use this. And the fact of the matter is, here is the proof that no one knew what was coming. This is Friday from CNBC. The host, after the markets were closed, and you know they were down significantly on Friday, she said, quote, "Does the speed of this correction tell us anything? Not just the fact that it happened, but that it happened so swiftly." Art Cashin answers, quote, "I think it showed that most people were not prepared for anything like it," end quote. There you got it. These are the top people on Wall Street. They didn't see it coming. As you mentioned, whether it was Dent, whether it's me, whether it's others you have on your show, there's only a few of us that have called it the way it is. They didn't see it coming. It's not about China. It's about a global slowdown.
Absolutely. I mean, you were on last week talking about this and saying it's imminent. And you look around the world, everything's going in the toilet. Then they say we're pessimist porn dealers. And they say that about you in New York Times. They say that about me in Time Magazine. And we're trying to stop the bubbles from expanding and blowing up. We're trying to say, what are you doing? We're trying to say, stop giving trillions to yourselves. If you're going to devalue currencies, at least give it to the people. So at least there's an economy. It has bad side effects, but it's better than what you're doing. And then they just ignore us, because the truth is they know what they're doing, Gerald. They're consolidating power. They want us poor to control us. They're going to use the global meltdown as a new power grab, my friend, and a Marshall Plan for the world. Look for that term. They always use it. They've been proposing it at Davos, $100 trillion per decade in new taxes run by the International Bank of Settlements, IMF, World Bank, based on SDRs, based on a basket of currencies and metals. They're already pushing it. This is their plan to say the world's too big to fail. Give us control during the meltdown. And just like the power grab in 2008, we'll be here in 7-8 years and it'll be even worse.
Yeah, that may well happen, but there's something bigger looming, and that's war.
Yes.
When all else fails, they take you to war. And that's all you're going to start hearing more and more.
And is that why the elites are running to the South Pacific?
You got it. This thing is out of control. As I mentioned, you go and read any of the comments from the people flooding into Macedonia, and they'll give you the countries, as I mentioned, Afghanistan, Libya, Iraq. But no one is saying, how come they're leaving these countries? Couldn't be because of the United States, could it? Bombing these places to hell and the people fleeing for their lives. No, they don't mention that. Oh, here's a big one. You know that Saudi Arabia is bombing Yemen, the poorest nation in the Middle East. They've slaughtered over 5,000 people already. It's not making the news. Let's put this together. You see where oil prices are. The Saudi budget to break even, oil has to be selling at $100 a barrel. We're talking now Brent crude down around 42. Now they've started a war. Remember that Saudi Arabia is about the third largest buyer of war equipment, bombs and planes and missiles each year. Now they're using that. So what we're saying is you're going to start seeing a great destabilization among the populations of these dictatorships like the United Arab Emirates, Qatar, Saudi Arabia. And I love it. They call them royal families. Yeah, like a princess kissed a frog, and the frog became a king. How about dictatorships set up by the English after World War One? So now we're going to see massive destabilization in these countries. That's why I'm saying to you that the biggest trend on the horizon to be aware of is an explosion in the Middle East that will be heard around the world as oil prices keep collapsing, currencies keep collapsing, the economies collapse, and they take the people to war, whether it's false flag or real.
And then you add the cherry on top. Clearly, they're activating the propaganda that liberty groups are going to start blowing up buildings with no evidence. Clearly, it's going to be a false flag. The elite are going to try to start a civil war domestically with gun owners. I mean, if they couldn't take over Baghdad, they're going to try to fight with their own military, basically. These people are insane, Gerald. Have they reached the bravado, chutzpah, arrogance, hubris point of no return?
Yes. Again, you know, people just sit back. It's not only now. How could they let a Hitler destroy their country? You know, these are the Germans in the 1930s at the height of Western civilization.
Amazing people.
Yeah, culturally, philosophically, scientifically. Bach, Beethoven, Wagner, Goethe. Think of the great names. From Fritz Lang to Marlene Dietrich.
All the big scientific discoveries, everything dominating the world with peaceful trade, and then they let him take over. Stay there. We're back in 60 seconds with Gerald Celente. Man, I tell you, this is a time to be awake and involved. Final segment. I want to say great job to the crew, all of our affiliates, listeners. Just, it's very humbling to be here. We are not telling you all this to scare you, and I know most of you know that, but mainstream media keeps acting like that Gerald Celente, myself, and others are porn dealers. Fear porn dealers is the term. And you know what? We have integrity. I mean, I tell you what I really believe. These MRAPs are for domestic groups. Watch, and then it comes out. Because I already had all the manuals saying their main enemy is the gun owner. So, of course, the MRAPs are for us. And then, of course, it comes out. Sometimes I make an extrapolation. I reach some because it's like stepping off in the dark. I know there's a step there. But most of the time, what I'm talking about is just admitted already. We have a giant, fraudulent, counterfeit derivative bubble of debt that isn't ours. We see what these globalists do to other countries. They want to basically enslave us now. They're starting wars with everybody. Gerald, we only got 4 minutes left. You got to come back soon. Sorry you got the power outage and got 10 minutes cut off, but what do you make of Kissinger coming out and saying the war against Russia has failed and criticizing Obama? What do you make of, can sanity prevail and these Wall Street elites stop playing general and not kill everybody?
No, they're out of their minds. They're psychopaths and sociopaths. I mean, you mentioned Hitler. How about Mussolini? You could keep going up and down the list. How about George W. Bush setting us to war based on lies? You know, it's one after another. And you're right about this gloom and doomer. I want to read this to you real quickly. This is from Thursday's CNBC. This is what this guy, Bob Pisani, says after the market closes. You know, I'll tell you what's frustrating to everybody. What exactly has changed in the last 48 hours in the world to see this kind of little mini collapse? Let's call it a collapse in the marketplace. I'm baffled by it. I get up this morning at 5:30. China's way down. I say, ooh, European Open is lousy. The future's lousy. I send out a note. Anybody know what's going on? Can you tell me a specific reason? Nobody gives me a reason. Just this vague sense. You ready? Of gloom and doom.
Yeah, this is, it's not that it's overvalued. It's not that there's a major global slowdown. It's not that all these wars have drained us. It's not the derivatives. All these pundits act like they don't know what's going on, Gerald. They do, though.
And again, they blame gloom and doom, like you were saying. They call us doomsayers. How about we see things differently than you do, and we have the facts to back it up, while you're just spewing out more about selling. I'll tell you what, Alex, this is a buying opportunity. How many times have you heard that over the last week?
Well, I think 5-10 years down the road, after it actually corrects to what the real earnings are, the P.E. ratios maybe, I mean, this stuff is way overvalued. This stuff is ridiculous. And when there's a world slowdown, obviously then I would expect stocks to go down unless we live in fairyland with the private banks running policy, basically just putting out free money. But still, it only dilutes the quality.
Again, that's why I'm bullish on gold. All of this, and again, you know well, we have no advertisers. Nobody pays me to say this. They're devaluing all the currencies. There's a currency crash going on around the world in front of everybody's eyes,
sure,
from Malaysia to Russia.
Gerald, I know you've got a really busy day coming up, and if you need to leave, that's fine. I would do it 12 minutes more so you could kind of have the floor when we come back. I won't be hurt if you got to go, though. You want to do 12 more minutes?
No, I'll do 12 more minutes. This is too important.
It is. I mean, I feel like I ought to be getting out of here myself and getting ready. You know, the old saying from Italy that the cobbler's children have no shoes. He's too busy making everybody else's shoes. I haven't gotten myself ready properly, Gerald.
Well, again, that's why I'm saying, here, if you lived in Russia and you just saw your currency devalue by 50% and you own gold and gold is based in dollars, you think you're better off owning the gold. The only reason the dollar is strong is because all the other currencies are so weak. Our retail numbers stink. Our job numbers, you know the
reality. That's right. Stay there. We're the best house in a bad neighborhood. Again, ladies and gentlemen, if you go back to the 1870s and the 1890s and 1904, there were runs on banks and runs on silver companies and runs on government bonds, and there were panics, and there were tulip bubbles in Europe worldwide where tulips were selling for hundreds of thousands of dollars, and then those bubbles would fall, and there were bubbles where people wanted a certain type of French bulldog, and a French bulldog would cost, you know, $1,000 in the 1890s or whatever in Paris, equivalent to like $100,000 today. But those are localized bubbles where if you want to be an idiot and pay the equivalent of $5 million for a tulip today, that's your problem. And if you want to be a shark, you can ride the bubble up knowing it's a bubble and then know when to get out. And it'd be one thing if the stock market had just become that. We know it's rigged, it's come out, the interest rates, the currency rates, all of it. The point is, the people running things have rigged it to be too big to fail, to suck in the whole society, to suck in the whole world, so that the entire planet is in danger, the civilization. And then they get us to commit to them, the managers that made the problem happen in the first place. It's premeditated. This is how we're going to get corporate world government. And so that's why it's essential to expose the big five mega banks as the people behind it. And they're the ones behind the open borders. And they're the ones behind coming after your guns. Every time you check, they're the ones behind pushing gender identity crisis on young people. They are the social engineers. They are the nasty people running the whole show. They are the ones getting ready for worldwide upheaval in Pentagon reports and Ministry of Defense reports back in 2007. This is engineered and ready. And they think out of this crisis, this cascade of crises, they're going to get full control. Gerald Celente, we've got about 11 and a half minutes left. You've got the floor. Break it down.
Yes, and as you were saying, how they try to, you know, you call people like you and I gloom and doomers. This is from Saturday's front page of the New York Times in the business section. Remember, the markets have just begun to collapse. This week's market sell-off may not be such a bad thing. If you step back just a bit, what's happened in the financial markets this week looks less like a catastrophe in the making and more like a much-needed breather when various markets had been starting to look a little bubbly. I'm not making this up. Here's how he closes. In the meantime, the best response for most investors trying to grapple with the latest bout of volatility is to take a deep breath. Right behind that, on B2, they call the New York Times the paper of record. How about the toilet paper of record? Here's the next story. Take some deep breaths and don't do a thing. That's the headline. Two headlines. The fire in the North Tower is under control. Go back to your offices. Remember that one? 9/11. And this is an economic 9/11 that's about to hit us. It's collapsing in front of us. It has nothing to do with markets being bubbly. It has to be with a commodity crash, a currency crash, because economies are crashing. You look at milk from New Zealand. Their exports are down like 60% because milk prices are plummeting. It's one after another. There's too much product and not enough demand. And we're going to see this continue.
And I sit here as a father of three, and I sit here as somebody who goes to eat at Luby's, which is just kind of a blue-collar, working-class, Texas-based, became a national chain of cafeterias. Been going there since I was about 2 years old. Like to take the kids there. And never in my life have I gone to Luby's, but also other restaurants, and seen people talking about old ladies, you name it, not being able to order the food they want and getting little bitty plates and watching old ladies get water instead of iced tea because they can't pay the dollar for the tea. And you can tell people don't have money. All the family I know, a lot of which are upper middle class, don't have anywhere near the money they used to have. Working class family I've got are all, you know, living together and barely able to pay to have gas to go to work, even though gas prices have gone down. The economy in most areas is in the toilet, as you know, and they just sit up there on the news saying everything's fine, everything's wonderful. It's just crazy to see this political class, and instead of handling all of this, there's national news stories going, the names boy and girl to be banned in public schools. You know, Caitlyn Jenner is a hero and has courage, and it's just... it's fantastical. It's like a Kurt Vonnegut novel that they give us all these weird issues to fight over while the country's being sucked dry and while the world's imploding. And then the third world, 6+ billion people of the 7.5 billion that want to come to the first world. The first world is, in many cases, super decadent and corrupt, other than the folks that are working. And I just don't know what all these backstabbers and people in the power structure are going to do once things get really bad. They think they're going to ride out the austerity and that it's going to be cute and funny. They think a police state's something they can control. I mean, they have literally laid the groundwork for their own destruction. The smart billionaires, as we talked about 30 minutes ago, have basically all fled or have jets fueled waiting to get out at any moment. To literal armored fortresses. But the mid-level richy rich types that are worth $1 million or whatever, you know, sitting in government swindling houses or corporate swindling positions, do they have any idea that people are going to come after them, Gerald?
No, they don't have any idea what's going on. Again, this guy, Art Cashin, saying that nobody expected this. And he's a guy I respect, by the way. He usually says it like it is. You look at all the headlines, and you see, Alex, headline after headline, they're blaming China. China has nothing to do with this. China's, as I said, it's the canary in the equity market mine. That's all it is. It's signaling if China can't make it, the reason they're not exporting things are because people aren't buying things.
It's simple.
Because there's a global meltdown.
It's exactly, you know, 10 years ago, they couldn't get enough ships to ship goods over here. I saw a statistic just a few weeks ago where it said that 60% of Chinese carrier ships are empty. That right there tells you everything you need to know, Gerald.
Well, you keep looking at it. You don't even have to go that far. You just go down to Savannah, and the shipping is way off. All of the numbers coming out from Europe going into China, from China going into Europe, it's way down. The facts are there. This has nothing to do with an equity bubble popping because of overvaluations, that's a reality.
How do we reverse it? Do you expect the establishment to try to reverse it, or are they just going to continue to QE?
No, they're going to more QE. I agree with, name slipped my mind.
Dent.
He's on your show. No, not Dent.
Schiff.
In the nest. I know exactly where you look.
Peter
like.
Schiff?
Peter Schiff has been saying QE indefinitely. I agree with Peter Schiff completely.
I'm going to skip this break and do a few more minutes with you to give me the last word, but I want to play a short clip of Mr. Dent with us back on the 13th of August, about a week and a half before this all accelerated, specifically saying he gives it a few weeks. You basically have been saying the same thing, and then I want to ask you, and I know you don't like to get totally exact because nobody can do that but God, but really putting your head in this, Gerald Celente of trendsresearch.com, in your gut, how do you see this unraveling? What's the main probability? I think that's a fair question. Let's play this clip.
The biggest thing since we last talked, China's bubble in stocks finally burst. It means nothing when a stock bubble bursts 10% or 20%. That can just be an ordinary correction. 35% in a little over 3 weeks. And how much would it have been if the government had not come in with a $500 billion fund to buy their own stocks? And this came after the government in China had been buying empty real estate to prop up that market that's been falling. And after they created the greatest bubble in history by moving $500 million people, low-skilled people, from rural areas to urban areas in the shortest period of time in history, China is the greatest bubble in history. It is finally coming unraveled. That's why I am confident that we are within, I'd say, weeks of the global bubble bursting again. China was the first thing. Actually, before that, in March, Germany, the leading market in Europe, looked like it peaked to me. And then the China crash in late May and end of July. And now I think the U.S. markets are going to start heading down by early September, probably peaking in the next week or two. So I think this is happening.
All right. Now let's go to a brief clip of Jack Lew. This is the Treasury Secretary a few weeks ago, saying that, don't worry, China is not connected to the U.S. Folks, we're more connected to China than any other country, hands down, no debating it. It's probably the biggest economy in the world because our numbers are cooked in the books. But regardless, second biggest economy, biggest sovereign owner of our debt, the Federal Reserve's the largest, period. Most of our manufactured goods come in. Our companies that are based here are pretty much manufacturing there. I mean, we are joined like Siamese conjoined twins here, ladies and gentlemen. And for them to say this is utter horse crap. And people say, oh, this guy must be an idiot. No, he's a con man up there to keep the little guys at the casinos. Listen, let me tell you what I saw. And Gerald talked about this last year. Austin, Texas, one of the nicest cities in the country. One of the prettiest, lower taxes. It's a very nice town, except for this time of year where it's 105 degrees. But great town. I go to the nicer areas, nicer restaurants, nicer places or whatever sometimes, and all I see is rich Chinese everywhere, okay? I mean, they have taken over. Fine. They got jobs, they got money, whatever. I don't have a problem with those immigrants. The point is, they look freaked out, though, and it's in the news. They're exiting all over the world. They're fleeing to what they think is safer, running, okay? While the news in China was saying, stay in the market, stay in the market, stay in the market, it's safe, it's safe. That's what's already happening here. Let's play this clip and then get Gerald Celente's take on it. Here is the Treasury Secretary.
But I will say that China's markets are still pretty much separated from world markets.
Horse crap.
They're obviously moving towards being more integrated, but right now they're not. So you're not going to, I don't think, see the direct linkage there. I think the concern that is a real one is, what does it mean about long-term growth in China?
As if China not growing doesn't affect us. What do you make of that statement, Gerald Celente, and then what Dent said?
Well, Dent obviously is right on. And what China, what Lew also did just a couple of days ago, actually Saturday was reported, he told China that they should constantly, remember, this is coming from our government telling somebody else what to do, that they should not concentrate on exports as much as they are, and that they should develop more of a consumer society. so that people could also shop until they drop, essentially. Here's what's really important, Alex. I've been around, you know, quite a while, and I've been following trends since 1980. I have never seen a summer like this. You don't see big market unravelings happening until late September, October. Because in the old days, people would go away on vacation and things would be quiet. This is the new world order. You're looking at volume levels that are near records in different sections. And this to be happening at the heat of the summer, at the quietest.
A trading low. Time. This is an artificial thing that's going on.
If this to be collapsing in August, you're asking me to put a timetable on things. For it to be collapsing in August, July and August, it's unprecedented in modern history. So what I'm saying to you, if you see this kind of collapse happening with high volume, it's not thin volume trading, because if it was, then you can say it's being manipulated. I'm saying to you that this thing is unstoppable. And that it's going to continue to unravel globally. What will happen in the U.S.? It's hard to say because of the tight controls of the Federal Reserve. I mean, they have their desk on the trading floor, for God's sakes. You know, they're right there. You know, so it's hard to say.
And by the way, when they first put in the plunge
protection control.
Sure. Well, when they first put the plunge protection team in, as you know, after the 87 crash, it was pretty much secret. It was kind of a rumor for the general public that it was actually propping things up. Now they admit it. Why don't you explain to new viewers or listeners how they're propping up our stock market? China did this, as you know, a few weeks ago, Gerald. It didn't end up working. Do you think it will work here?
Yes, it'll work here more efficiently. Because it's tighter control, and these guys are more savvy at doing it. Having said that, they only could prop it up to a point. And remember, when you go back to the 87 crash, you know, following it, they propped it right back up. And the crash should have went a lot worse. So the crash may happen. They'll prop it up. It'll be a phony prop. The Chinese do not have the skills that the Americans have in playing this game. They're rookies at it. You can see what they did when the Shanghai index was collapsing. They prevented short selling. They prevented people from selling grade A shares for 6 months. They dumped in 200 trillion plus into the markets, and they also pulled off almost 50% of the tradable shares. What they'll do in the States, I believe, to calm it, is after the plunge protection team does its job, they'll call a holiday. They'll quiet things down.
Holiday.
That's right. Let's have a Wall Street. They did it after 9/11. People forgot it. Wall Street was closed for a week.
Well, you see the head of Citibank and all these groups saying, let's ban cash so they can really control us and just steal the money right out of the accounts.
And by the way, when they open it up after the holiday, they'll do exactly like they did when Roosevelt did it. They'll devalue the currency, because back then the dollar was pegged to gold. It was selling for what, about $22.60 an ounce. When they forced the people to turn in all their gold bullion coins certificate, they reschedule it. They repeg it to $35 an ounce. They just robbed that amount of money from the people, and that's what they'll do this time.
Well, I don't want to say I disagree with Dent. You and he and Schiff are all pretty close on a lot of fronts because it's just common sense, but it's still three guys look at the same problem from different perspectives. They're going to have different answers, and I think between all your answers and my own research is where you find, you know, the truth, but time will tell on that. But he's right. They've got a depression worldwide, but they're also accelerating the currencies, which devalues, so it kind of averages out and only helps the elite because they get first use of the money. But he thinks gold will go down for the next 10 years, then finally explode after that because other commodities will go down. But I see the elites themselves quietly hoarding it and institutions hoarding it, and that makes me think they know something we don't know. And I know they've talked about this new SDR they're already using at the IMF World Bank level, a new level of bubbles, Gerald, of fiat currency that is backed by a spectrum of currencies and other commodities mixed in with gold and silver that are commodities, obviously, at least 30%. They've proposed that before. And he says, oh, no, they'll never do it. It's not a good commodity to use. It should just be, you know, fiat or whatever. The point is they're proposing that. Then they could play and manipulate all those little markets that are within the basket, which is what these insiders love. And so that's where I see all this going. What comes in closing from Trends Journal, in your view, what comes out of this if these guys win? What type of world will it be?
Well, again, that may happen, what you said, but remember when Bretton Woods happened. It happened after the war.
Yes.
So that might happen after the war. And I respectfully disagree with Dent, because you kept talking, and he was saying about the currency devaluations. If your currency is being devalued, wouldn't you rather own gold than a devalued currency? And when you're looking at the declining prices of gold compared to copper, nickel, aluminum, it's not even close.
Absolutely. Well, listen, even if it's going to go down in value, it's better than cash that can be completely devalued. So you hold it as a hedge regardless, but absolutely, this stuff's all got to go down sometime. And so when they revalue it or whatever, just in my gut historically too, it tells me gold, silver, and other things are going to be more valuable.
Exactly. And I believe when gold prices go up, they're going to spike up.
Now his cell phone has gone out. This third world nation, Kingston's got the power off. Austin has its power go off all the time now, too. They've shut down most of our power plants. Then gouge us. We only have the power plants owned by GE and insiders. So, you know, I guess Ceaușescu just only let the Romanians have their power 1 hour a day, but he got power all the time. He had his own little city. And he did that on purpose, he said. It's to control them, let them know I'm the boss. I will decide when they get power. Sometimes on a holiday, give them maybe half a day of power.
Hello? Or,
yes, you're back. Your cell phone cut out. You got 1 minute, Gerald. TrendsResearch.com. Thank you so much. What's the closing comment?
All right, again, let's stay on with this with the gold. We said that the bottom of gold was about $1,000 to $1,150. We can't see it going down much lower than that because it doesn't pay to pull it out of the ground at after 1,000. And again, what we're saying is if your currency is being devalued, why not own gold? So our forecast is that when gold prices go up, they're going to spike up and they're going to break well over the 2,000 mark.
Well, Dent thinks when it finally does go back up 10,000, I mean, regardless, down the road, I don't see how it couldn't go up.
We're talking within a shorter period. We think we're near the bottom of gold. And we think from this point forward, you know, it can go down another 100, 150, but if the upside potential is going to happen, and when it happens, we're saying it's going to happen in spikes.
All right.
And it's going to leave a lot of people shut out.
Well, thank you. You'll be here with us.
Since the beginning of time, it's not going anywhere.
All right. Thank you, Gerald Celente. Great job. Nightly News tonight, 7 o'clock.